start broadcasting. And that's at you, so now I'm gonna... It's okay, it's not your face, don't worry. Okay, hi everybody. Hopefully that stands up. We're doing new consultant training today, and so we're just going to kind of start. I want to go really quickly with some of the mistakes that I made as a brand new beauty consultant, and then move into just the really big basics, like what the heck's in your kit, right? What are you going to do with it? How are you going to do an appointment just with your kit? And then what you're going to do to get more things in it, okay? First of all, okay. So the very first thing, the mistake that I made as an independent beauty consultant is I did not operate with a sense of urgency. So no matter what you're doing, and I know it's really, really easy to say things like, well, I'm only going to see where it goes. That's usually a lie you're telling yourself in one way or another because of fear, okay? So you don't have to tell me where you're going with this. You don't have to tell your director, whatever. Just tell yourself what you really, really, truly want. If I were able to say and grab a magic wand and say, go for it. You're successful. What would that look like? What would successful look like to you? Some people successful is $600 a month. Some people successful is $6,000. Some people successful is $60,000. And some people like me will never see themselves as successful because they always want to keep going. So that's okay, right? So whatever it looks like to you is fine because there is a place for everybody. But make a goal and then have a sense of urgency towards meeting that goal, whatever it is. Okay, so if it's going to cost you $200 to buy your product, if you have to do $400 in sales to buy $200 of product for yourself, mm-hmm. then that's your urgency. Yeah. It doesn't have to be, I'm going to be a director, I'm going to earn a car, I'm going to get a diamond ring. It can be something as simple as that. But just, I didn't operate with that sense of urgency. I sort of floated. Okay, number two, and we're going to cover this, I didn't get great at closing the sale. So make sure that no matter what, you get really, great. Sorry. Closing the sale. I think that might be too slidey. Thanks. That'd be great. Awesome. Sorry. And then Krista's heard of black. That's okay. Because, and number one, the reason why I didn't get good at closing the sale is because I was worried about being pushy. Here's what I know. None of you are attracted to Mary Kay or to our team, especially because you're pushy. And pushy people never realize that they're pushy. And they would never worry about being pushy. So if any one of you is worried about being pushy, then you're probably not pushy. It's true, right? Because that's the problem, is that we're not in this business to be pushy. So, but you're losing out on things. One of the things that I did in the beginning, in my first like 100 faces, I sent out a survey and I asked them like, what could I do differently? You know what the number one answer was? You could have let me buy stuff. Because I didn't let them. I would total it up too early. I would go, no, you don't need that. And then later they'd be like, well, I want it. You know, so I didn't do that because I was so worried about it. Number three, I spent too much time talking in the appointment instead of listening. So I want you to, in the beginning of your appointments, sometimes a bracelet works. Okay, as a reminder. So whatever a visual reminder is for you to say, stop talking. I often would write the word wait on the inside of my wrist. Why am I talking? Mm-hmm. Just remember this. She who talks next takes the product home. If you want to carry it there and take it home with you, whether that's virtually or in real life, keep talking. If not, shut up. Okay, there's a video I used to watch all the time, and it's this little Southern national, I can't remember her name, but she would always go like, and then you be quiet, and you let her choose. And that was really important to me because people talk too much when they're trying to close the sale. Number four, I didn't see the point in team building. So I'm going to emphasize this later about adding to your team and how important it is, even as a branded beauty consultant, and even as somebody who doesn't want to make a ton of money or do a lot with this business, because the person you recruit may want to do a lot or do a, you know, and I have to tell you, my recruiter, her recruiter, okay, so my recruiter was number three in Canada, number two in Canada, number three in Canada, like she sells well over $80,000 a year retail in product, okay? Her recruiter is not a director and maybe has five people on her team. She sort of sells a little bit. She makes enough money off of that recruit to take her family to Disney World every single year. And she does not train her. She does not do anything for her. She just makes that money from that. Okay? So I want you to think about that, that you could be not only changing her life the way that this recruiter did, but you could also be making residual income for like forever. And you are not responsible to train anybody. I do not want the blind leading the blind. So don't worry. Okay. And you don't have to find people who just want everything, because most people, like you guys, didn't say, nobody said, I signed up because I'm going to be a national sales director. I'm going to take over the world. I'm going to make $1 million in this business. We may want to.
I need one diamond in each finger.
That's right. That's right. Hey, yeah. You're going to run out of fingers. I already have. But nobody does that. I didn't. You know, Gail didn't sign up for that. Our national sales director signed up because she wanted to buy bikes for her boys, because she had just gotten divorced. She was working two jobs, and her kids didn't have brand new bikes for Christmas like everyone else did. That's all she wanted. As soon as she bought those bikes, she was going to quit. Now she's been to like 42 countries and is $1 million director or national sales director. Okay. Number five, I did not track. So I want you to get really good at knowing what the prizes are. There aren't very many that we do in our unit, and there aren't very many that Mary Kay offers. Don't miss them. They're pretty easy to get, and most people miss them because they didn't track them. It's pretty simple. Okay. So figure it out. Just do, you know, a sheet or whatever. To track them every month. Number six, I bought too many things, especially samples. Be really careful. It's very easy to go, well, I mean, I'm not going to sell that if I don't. I have to spend money to make money. Who's heard that? Okay. No, not true. Okay. Yes, you have to have some demos. Yes, you have to have some samples, but you don't need one of every eyeshadow sample, and you definitely don't need 15 of every eyeshadow, and you definitely don't need to give one customer 12 of them so she can take them home and try them on. No, there's no money to be made in that. Number seven, I didn't ask. I didn't ask for the party. I didn't ask for the referral. I didn't ask for the booking. I didn't ask because what I was afraid of was being pushy, right? Okay, number eight, this may not be something you do, but I definitely did. I talked a lot about what I wanted in my future in the business, but I didn't do the work to back it up. So I talked too big. I talked a lot about like $1 million directors and cars, and I'm going to earn a car. And then I realized I was nowhere near earning a car, and I needed to shut up and get to work. Okay, so sometimes you're going to be excited, and sometimes you need to temper that with work. Number nine, I had business ADHD. And life ADHD. I had too many things going on. Be careful. If you're going to focus, focus stands for follow one course until successful. So just, you know, I was running a jewelry business. I was selling on Etsy. I was tutoring in the evenings. I was doing Mary Kay. And you know what I found was when I started concentrating just on Mary Kay, I made 3 times as much money as I was doing 3 different things and being stressed out about it. Focus. And number 10, I didn't learn how to manage my money and track my income. And we are really tight in our unit about money management. That's a huge thing for us. I do not want anybody going into debt that they can't control. Investment is different than debt, but I don't want you getting, you know, like a lot of you said that the reason you signed up was to avoid debt. I don't want you going, well, okay, Carol, that was a great business, but now I'm $5,000 in debt in freaking samples. And I had to buy a new office and they had to decorate it before I could sell anything. I mean, duh. Right? So we're really going to be careful with money management. Okay. All right. So first things first, you guys need new consultant pins. Do you have these already? No? Anybody?
I do.
Yes. You do. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Look at Jill doing her job. I never do these. I never hand these out. Like I'm the worst for these. Okay. These are for when you go to a meeting, but they really work to wear on your coat, especially in the winter. Just pop it on your coat. Pop it on your coat. If you really want my advice, put it on upside down. People have this compulsive need to flip it. It's like they're like, oh, just a minute. Oh, you sell Mary Kay. Sure do. Would you like a catalog? Should we have an appointment? And you're done. That's it. Okay? That's as simple as that. You don't have to say a word. Just put it upside down. I don't know what it is. It just really, really works, okay? It's kind of funny. And then as you move up the career path, we'll get you different extenders for these, okay? Questions, comments, concerns so far? No? All right, I'm going to unpack a starter kit. Look how pristine this is. There's still plastic on the handle. Starter kit. Okay, so you guys can unpack your own if you want while we do it, or you can just watch me. That's cool. Nobody can see me now.
I think still in there.
Yeah, I think so. Okay, so first of all, your kit came with catalogs. These are not called catalogs on the order form. It's very important information. These are called the lookbook. If you look for catalogs, you are going to have a bad time. And then you'll be, and usually these are the text messages I get at 9:54 when orders are due at 10 o'clock. Where are the catalogs? The lookbook. It's always the lookbook. And we get only 4 a year. So it makes it really, really simple. Okay, there's a new one coming out November 15th. So don't overstock on these ones because the next level will be out. Okay, so you don't have to worry. However, don't throw out your old ones. I can't tell you how many people are like, oh, well, it's done. No, the prices don't really change. The products don't really change. And if somebody falls in love with some limited edition product, unless it's sold out, somebody in our unit has one that you can trade for something else. Okay, so if they're like, well, but I really want the Metro Modern Pellet, you do not need to go cry and say, well, I don't have that. It's a catalog of gold. Doesn't matter. Okay, so I use these for my like trade shows, warm chatter tools. I carry lots in my purse. I bag them up. I put them in a little, you know, those birthday bags, like those kinds of like cellophane bags. And I put my business card and a couple of samples in. And then when I talk to somebody, I'm like, here's a little Prezi for you. Okay, easy. Okay, it's a hit and run. It's not super effective, but we're going to talk later about finding new people. And this is not the time. Okay, so catalogs. The lookbook is really simple because the back of the lookbook is always the same. So actually here, if you can pass these around so everybody can sort of follow along. See these last pages, starting with the miracle set, these are all the same. So they don't usually change, okay? It's the fronts that do. So the fronts just choose to feature different products. In the beginning as a brand new beauty consultant, what I did with old catalogs was I cut out these looks and put them in those page protectors and stuck them in a binder so that I could learn the looks. And I would buy the samples only for that look for advanced beauty appointments. So not the ones that you do with your color card, but like the next level stuff. Okay, so in the next 6 months to a year or whatever, as you're building your samples, or I would buy the full size of those. So I would say, okay, this look is Kohl, Silver Satin, and that's it, and then Jet Black Eyeliner. So I would buy Kohl and Silver Satin in full sizes. And then I would buy all of these, but then the next catalog, I'd get 4 different looks, but I wouldn't have to, lots of those were repeat eyeshadows. So then I would slowly build up my palette of demo eyeshadows. Does that make sense? Then I only opened the catalog and said, pick a look. There's 4. What look do you like? And look, the instructions for the look are right here. You can go like this. Apply the sparkling white to the brow bones and inner corners of the eyes to highlight. Okay, do that. And then watch her do it. Okay, now use the City Sophisticate Eye Color Palette and blend the taupe shadow all over the eyelids and into the crease. That's all I did. Okay, nobody in this room is a makeup artist, including me. I learned from here. Okay, so there's 4 different looks in here. In the fall one, it's usually a very dark look. Spring and summer are very light looks. So fall and winter are darker and just like normal. And spring and summer are lighter. If you have a full year's worth and you're around for a full year, then you have a full year's worth of catalog options that are in your little book. You can put them in a photo album or whatever. A lot of girls carry those little mini, you know, the ones you can buy at Michael's for like $1. Stick them in there and then say, here are my looks. Which one do you want? Okay, that way you don't have to get one of every single lipstick. Because ain't nobody using one of every single lipstick. I've never had an appointment where somebody's like, well, let me try every single one. Her eyes would be blood red. Or her eyes. Don't put lipstick in your eyes.
They would be blood red.
Your lips would be blood red when you were done. So these are really easy to start with, okay? As well, what I loved is that they always feature a product. So when you're getting to know a product, like the microdermabrasion set, when in the beginning, Serum C first came out when I first started, and I clipped that out of the catalog and put it in my training so that I would remember what it said about Serum C, because it'll never say that again. In the back, it'll say replenishes and revitalizes. Thanks. You know, and there is stuff in the consultant guide online, but, you know, sometimes you don't have that readily available. You can take this and put this as pictures in your phone, too. You don't have to keep them on paper. If you're more techie, take a picture of it, create a little album on your phone, flip through the album, okay? Doesn't have to be crazy. Do not stress. Yeah, but they just kind of go through the different things that are involved in the catalog. We don't tend to teach from the catalog at all, so you don't have to worry about this. These are just there. So again, don't throw them out. Keep them, and we get a new one every quarter, okay? And you do have to order those. They're only $7, though, for 20. So they're really cheap.
So when the new one comes out, like November 15th, you have to order them.
Well, you do. Yeah, I mean, you don't have to, but you should on your next order.
If you need
get some. Yes, yeah. And these will still get you through. So if you're at a party, you're like, oh, no, I have a party on November 17th, and I don't have the new. No one knows.
It's just going to be missing that few new products that come out.
Right? Nobody cares. I've never had one single person go, excuse me, this actually says fall 2015? Never. Okay? Never, ever. And you know, like, our miracle set's been 157 since the day I bought it in 2004. Okay? 157. It does not change. When the eye makeup remover went up from $17.50 to $19, we got a 3-month warning. Just so you know. Like, it's a whole $1.50. Meanwhile, the size of it has changed and gotten bigger over the years, and the price never did. So we're good. We're sticking around. These are your beauty books, and they are your bestest friends. Okay. Oh, here. Let's pass the catalogs back, though, so that Janice doesn't end up with nothing. She's like, thanks a lot, Carol. Really appreciate this empty kit you gave me. Okay. So I'm going to open this. So what's really cool about the beauty books is it's a party guide. Right there, or a facial guide in the front. And it has a menu set shelf, a selling sheet right here. Look at that. Okay? So everybody gets one of these at the party. And again, we'll pass these around, but don't steal them, okay? Don't lick it either. I know you were going to tell me I was watching.
You know. If I lick it, it's mine.
It's
right?
Tempting, right? If I lick it, it's mine.
I work with
you. Tina, did you get one?
Oh.
There you go.
Thank you.
Yes, exactly. Okay. So this, here, hang on. This is like really heavy. Okay. Where did I put the, did I give somebody the guide?
Right. In
did you get?
Right there.
Not this.
Oh, no.
The big book. There it is. Thank you. Okay. So this is your instructor's guide. There is an app for that. It's called the Show and Sell app. You really want to look amazing for your group or your facial? Get the app. It's beautiful. Mary Kay spends a ton of money making these things for you. Use them. Okay, the app works. It's right exactly like the beauty book. You can even plug it into the TV through the like USB or thingers at a hostess's house and play through it with your iPad. I mean, it doesn't get better than that. So you're in the kitchen with them and their TV happens to be there. If it's not, though, then you might have to be from your iPad. So this has notes that you can give yourself right here. You can write your own notes, and it has your dialogue. So it'll say, the opening of the class gives you an opportunity to thank your guests. Say, hi, I'd like to welcome everybody and thank so-and-so for, don't read it like this, for hosting this party. Okay, try and memorize it, but I'm going to let her choose a special gift from the great Mary Kay products she loves. I offer a gift to all of my hostesses, and I'm very happy to tell you how you can get your own at the end of the party. You don't have any gifts to give her yet. So she has to get a gift and order it, right? Because you have nothing, so that's okay. And this is your skincare party. You're going to read what Mary Kay Ash did, and they follow along. So look at the next page. Look at that. That's Mary Kay Ash. And you're going to read about it. Mary Kay Ash, she was a visionary leader. She founded her company on the Golden Rule and emphasized the importance of giving back to others. In the beginning, I had people at the party read it. I still have people at the party read it. You know, so I'll be like this, Dina, can you read what Mary Kay Ash did? Or I'll be like this with tickets. Okay, tickets to your friend at a party, tickets to your friend. Who knows who this is? Mary Kay! Okay, when did she start her company? 1963! Ticket, okay? That's what you need to do. You need to create energy. Nobody likes to go to a party where their hostess is like, okay? But it's just really great because this gives you some basic information that you can memorize and use. Then you go through the opportunity. Mary Kay realized that people needed an opportunity to achieve financial success. You don't have an iStory yet, but you can say why you started your business. It's totally fair. I just started. And I started because I saw... Don't do this. And then I thought it would be fun. And then make a little bit of money. OK, Okay, but, you know, you're going to be a little bit more excited than that, but just, you know, give them an idea. And then the next one is what you offer them and what they want, and then you go to, right into the skincare for them. I usually get one person at each in each age bracket to read the 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s. Or it's kind of fun to get the 20-year-olds to read the 50s one and the 50-year-olds to read the 20s one, because then the 50-year-olds are like, oh, remember when my skin looked like that? And then I always say, do you feel like that's true? Do you feel like that's what's happening to your skin right now? Oh, you're in your 30s. Do you feel like you're getting drier? Do you feel like that's happening? Yeah. Now, guess what? Because it said so in the book, and she agreed with the book, now she believes everything in the book. Psychology, okay? So now she agrees with you. She agrees with the book. So now she feels like you're a skincare expert, and all you did was tell her exactly what it said there. That's it, okay? Don't forget to emphasize the buyback guarantee on the side, okay? 100%, no matter what, okay? And then each of the things here has a script for it, but I don't even worry about those. You are working on the miracle set only. So you're going to go like this. You're going, here, I need one in front of me. You're going to start with, sorry. So really quick on who Mary Kay was, really quick on the opportunity, and then go through these different ages. There is an app for that. So if they have the app, they can actually, and I do get them to download it at the table because it's not a lot of space, or they go on the hostess's Wi-Fi. They get to pick the model and then slide the slider across for how many wrinkles they have compared to the model. And then it will tell them, not you telling them, that they need skincare, okay? Because sometimes they're like, I haven't washed my face in 10 years, and people compliment me on my skin all the time, and you're like, they do now, hey? Or they say, how old do you think I am? And then you say 50, and it turns out she was 38. And I thought I was being super nice with the 50. Mm-hmm. Yeah. She was already grandma at 38 as well, so she had talked about her grandchild, so I figured I was safe with 50. No.
Never safe answering someone's age. No.
She also thought that I should get into the stripper market, because apparently I know a lot of them, but she does. So then her daughter is a stripper, and then felt the need to show me her Facebook profile, including full nudity of her daughter. This is one of my very first parties. True story. Mm-hmm. Yes. If Audra's periscoping in, she knows what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I had to go, aw. And she's like, look, you can hardly tell. She just had her baby. Anyway, these things make for better stories. Okay, so go through the age groups, then go right to the miracle set. Okay? You're going to quickly say, we do have four skincare lines. I just do it like, we do have four skincare lines. We're focusing on one today, but all of our skincare lines are mix and matchable, and we may have to find the right combination for you. Today, we're doing this. At your next appointment, you can try one of these if you think something else is a better fit. Again, next appointment, because you want to create more than one appointment with them. We are not in the business of selling one time. We're in the business of layering appointments so that they see us more than once. They create relationships with us. Okay, so you're going to really quick go through the benefits of the miracle set. That's on this page in the guide. So you don't have to, there's nothing here. You're going to just, that's my son. Say hi, Case. He's like, oh my God. Yeah, there's a whole script right here. So you can use the script. You can also, there's videos on it on MKOC and everything else on the miracle set. You don't have these two pieces of the miracle set yet, but you will. And it doesn't matter, because if you talk about it and romance it enough, you'll sell it anyway, whether they try it or not. Because if they like the cleanser and moisturizer, chances are they're also going to like the day and night solution. And if they don't, guess what? There's a return policy. Okay, so that's all you're doing is the miracle set. Then, guess what? She has to do the miracle set. So she's going to use the cleanser and moisturizer from your kit. That's what she's trying with. We're going to get through how to do a facial, and I'm going to do from start to finish right now, but I'm just unpacking the starter kit. Don't worry about the rest of this book. This is a great book to give her to take home because it has a lot in it, but at the very back, the best part about this book is that it has everything labeled by the age groups and what she should have in her age bracket. These are the non-negotiables. So I always say these are the non-negotiables that Mary Kay recommends for your age group. Easy. Come in. Hi. This book doesn't change very often. Doesn't change every quarter. And if it does change, we get a notice about it. So we just had a new one. But otherwise, it didn't change. No, you're okay. Don't worry. There isn't an extra chair, though. But there is a taller one, if you don't mind. Okay, perfect. You can bring it forward, though. Don't sit way over there with your face in the corner. It's not very nice of me.
Would this be the beauty book when you order it?
This is called the beauty book. Yes. Okay, so this is your best tool. A lot of consultants don't use this. I don't even know why. Here's the thing. Customers need to try the product. They need to see the product. There's something dripped on me.
Oh. Because I was using it.
Oh, okay. I was like, I thought it was from the ceiling. I was a little worried. I was like, no. Because there's only my bathtub above there, and I don't think anyone's in it. So then Halloween and yeah. They need to see the product. They need to try the product. They need to hear about the product, and they need to read about the product. And when they get all those things layered together, then they're more likely to, understand and to be on board with you. It's like you've verified for them that it's true, okay? So go through at the end of your appointment, go through the end piece and circle the things that she wants right now and the things she might want later. Put your information on the back and give this to her when she's done. Because this will sell you way more than this. Keep these, give this. That's my advice. This is too overwhelming. She flips and flips and flips and buys nothing. This is focused on skincare, which is your money. That's your money. Don't be fooled into thinking Mary Kay is about makeup, because it is not. It's the dessert. Skincare, skincare, skincare. Okay? Any questions about the beauty book? This one has water. No, okay. Okay, so pass these back. Sorry. And again, show and sell app. Don't forget to get the app. There's an app for that. The other thing in your kit is the personal profile cards. These are your customer profiles. These are super important. Please use these. They are so easy. The name and phone number, how they want to be contacted, and then they chickity, chickity, chickity here. I don't know if you know this. I'm sorry. I'm totally molesting your kid. It's a whole virginity thing. I'm stealing. I'm breaking the hymen of this whole kit here. It's happening, okay?
I wonder why you get weird followers.
I was just thinking the same thing.
I got a lot of hearts for that one. Okay. Okay, so I'll pass these around to you and make sure you give them back as well. Because, they're like gold.
Yeah, I don't have any left.
You don't? Oh, I have lots. Don't forget to... I can give you some before we go.
Thanks. Okay, quite a three.
Oh, sorry. It was a take one and pass around. Okay. So, here's the thing. So, she's checking off all these little boxes. Whatever she checks off, the flip is open. This is an ooh-ah moment. Whatever she checks off, it will tell you exactly what product to recommend to her.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh. So if she checks off that she wants age fighting in her foundation in number 5, it's going to recommend the TimeWise Matte Wear or Luminous Wear liquid foundation, because that's the age fighting one. It took me 2 years to realize this. So if you didn't get it, that's okay. All right. But it's really great because it's a great recruiting tool. So when I'm sitting with the person, especially because most of what you're doing is not parties, you're mostly doing facials, you're mostly doing one-on-one. When I'm sitting with her and I check it off, then I open it like this and I just go, okay, so look, so this is recommending for you the Miracle Set. It's recommending for you the Dark Spot Reducer. Some of these things we're going to try today. Some we can try at your follow-up appointment, or some you might just want to give a go and see what they're like, because we have the return policy. Boom, boom. Okay? Easy. You keep this. On the back... The first one, number 8, is the first question I ask her before we even start. What skincare products are you currently using? And I usually follow that up with, what do you like about them? What do you like about that? Because whatever she likes about it is pretty much what I'm going to hit in ours. So if she only uses soap and water, and I say to her, well, what do you like about that? Because usually I can't control my face, sort of. I have a plastic face. I have rubber face. It's like it can't control anything. I'll say, what do you like about that? And she's like, well, it's easy. Well, so are these. you know, and so then, and I don't do it like, well, so are these, but like, but you are going to hit up the easiness of this system. You're not going to hit up all the other age fighting benefits because she doesn't give a rip or she wouldn't be using soap in the first place. Okay. She wants easy. So you will give her easy. If she likes that it's age fighting, she might like that it's a premium brand. Well, so's ours. We just don't have the premium prices because we don't have to pay an 18-year-old girl to work the kiosk at the Sears Center. Okay. We don't have any overhead. We don't have to do all of those things. Then number 9, this is the most important thing on this whole thing. They will forget what you tried. Even though all you're trying in the beginning is satin hands and cleanser and a moisturizer, some CC cream, and maybe a color card, she will still forget. She forgets. So your goal is to remind her. So every single thing you try, you ask her if she wants it on the wish list. If you're doing a party, you guys who have seen me do this at the events, if you're doing a party, every time that they write it on their wish list, they get a ticket for that. Because then at the end, she's looking at all this list. I don't worry about number 10 or number 11. I tell them to write right over top of those suckers. But every single thing. So we just tried the satin hands at the sink. Did you want to put that on your wish list? And then she'll go, yeah. And I'll say, peach or fragrance free. Or sometimes she won't answer me, because just like Janice just stared at me. See that? She was like, I don't know. Okay. So I'll be like, Janice, you love that satin hands, right? Did you want to put it on your wish list in peach or fragrance free?
Peach.
Yeah. See? She only had to make two decisions. She's like a toddler. Do you want to go outside or sit here? Those are it. Not, do you want to go outside and play and maybe put on your boots and maybe we could do the, no. Okay. Do you want peach or fragrance free? Great. Once you have broken the seal on this, like the first pee after you've been drinking. It's important. You break the seal. And I'm so glad that somebody just joined as I just said that. Once you break the seal on this, that's good. Because then she's going to be more likely to be receptive to writing down other things. I do say to her, this is not a contract. You do not have to buy everything on the wish list. Like, I'm not going to scream at you. But otherwise what happens is my customers will call me and they'll be like, I need some more of that thing. With the stuff, like we tried it. So, and I'll look and I'll be like, oh, the firming eye cream. Yeah, the stuff. They don't know. Okay. And any lip colors they like, anything like that, then that way I can write it down for them. If I'm at a facial, I control it. I write it down. If I'm at a party, they control it. They write it down, but I give them tickets for doing it. Every product. If you can't remember, put some bracelets on your wrist. I love bracelets for that. To whatever you need to be remembering. Every time I say follow-up appointment, I would often put 7 bracelets on one hand. And then every time I said it, I would move them over. If you don't like bracelets, put 7 little beads in front of you. Those little flat rocks you can buy, you know, put them in front of you. They'll ask you, what are those for? And you're like, to ask you for your follow-up appointment because I'm not giving you good customer service if I only see you once. They appreciate that. So, and they'll remind you, you said follow-up appointment. Oh, okay. I'll move it over, okay? Bracelets, they don't notice. Beads, they do. If you have trouble with those things, if you have trouble with remembering that you're going to tell them about the product, count up how many products there are and put those little beads over and move them over or put them in your pocket or throw them in your kit when you're done so that you remember that each of those things needs to be put on the wish list, okay? Because if she has a wish list, when she's done, she doesn't go and buy the very last thing you put on her face, which is probably mascara, and then you've walked away with a $21 sale, and you're like, I don't understand this Mary-Kate thing. This does not work. Okay? Good? So this is your friend. At this part, in the pink part, you're going to put everything you tried on her, her foundation shade, the colors you did, what she liked, what she didn't like. This is your file on her. Don't write was super mean. Not while she can see it. And then keep it. And I don't stress the keeping. Don't stress. You do not need a filing cabinet. There, you probably have 30 customers in the beginning, okay? You need one of those little A to Z accordion thingers with the elastic that goes around it at Dollarama, okay? Every appointment that you see her, once she's done buying, you're going to staple the white copy. After you've done your order and stuff, you staple the white copy of the receipt to the back of this. Then if I have my follow-up appointment with her, I'm going to bring it. And now I know what she bought already, what she didn't buy, what she liked last time. And she's not refilling out a profile card every single time. Easy. Okay? Any questions about that? You sure? It's crickets in here, man. Okay. So, profile cards, hand them back. Tammy's in charge. Okay.
Tammy likes being in charge.
Sure.
Here are the order forms. Oh, here they
were. I'll hand you because you're yours.
Make sure I touch on this again before. I didn't give it back to you, but I don't want to touch on it yet. Okay, order forms. These are not called order forms on the order form. The ones you get that are $0, you're nodding, you know this. The free ones are just a sheet of everything that you can buy and send in by fax or mail. For those people who do not have computers. But there are people. And so you don't want those. You want these. They're called sales slips. They say bilingual sales slips, and they cost money. If they cost money, they're the right thing. They're cheap. Like, they're like $3.50 or whatever. But they're not the $0 ones. Do not. Kristen bought like 500 ones.
I heard.
She was like, they're free. And then she got a whole box of them. Just... What are these, Carol? The wrong thing. That's what those are. Okay, so don't do that. All right. On your order form, this is not in her hands. I got lipstick on the back of this.
Now you have to buy something.
Now I have to buy something. These are not in her hands. A lot of times, and a lot of direct sales companies will hand everybody a clipboard. They write in their own order form. Guess what? They only buy then what they've already budgeted to buy. And they do all their adding, and they're confused, and it's a lot of work, and they go, I'm spending $50, so I'm only buying $50. No. I don't care if it's at a party. I don't care if it's at a facial. It's not in her hands. You fill this out. And I'm going to go over how to close the sale later, so I'm not doing that part. But basically, her basic information's at the top. That's really easy. Oh, here. You guys might want a visual tool. Sorry. Okay. So customer name, address, city, whatever. Okay. And credit card number. You don't have to put this credit card number on anymore. You all have the Square, right? Okay, if you don't have the Square, get the Square. It's an app to collect credit cards.
It's free.
And it's free, and you just go shunk, and then you don't have to keep her number and worry about somebody breaking into your house and stealing the numbers, okay? So you don't have to write the number down unless she's calling in. It's called the Square. It's the best one. It is. It's really awesome. The money goes in your account in 2 days. It's super, super easy, very easy to set up. It's awesome.
It doesn't cost a lot.
No. And the processing fees, fees are cheaper than anything else. Mm-hmm.
They take a little money out before, like when you sign up. Initially, mm-hmm. They'll take the money out. I was like, what?
They do it on purpose to make sure that the bank machine works.
Make sure it works.
It's a dollar, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It looks weird, though, because you're like, this was free, and they charged me a buck. No, it's like totally normal. Okay, so you're going to write the quantity of the items, the description. The description's for you, so you don't have to be... Super, super, oh, somebody, hi, okay, if you refer someone, you get $1,000 of free processing, apparently, I don't know.
On the Square.
Yeah, on the Square,
yeah.
Oh. Yeah. I'm referring all of you, make sure you put my name, Carol Thompson. wow, because I refer a lot of people to that.
The new person and, like, the referral and the referee.
Oh.
Marina got it when I signed up.
Well, what do you get? $1,000 of free processing fees.
So they don't charge you the processing.
Wow.
And every time.
Yeah. Wow. Carol Thompson referred you. Yeah. It costs money to process credit cards.
If you don't swipe the credit card, it costs more.
Yes. Yeah. So make sure you get the little swiper.
You have a swipe. 3.5% and it's 2.5% if you swipe it.
Okay. It says send them the email link and then you get the free processing fees. So if you haven't set up the Square yet... I'll send you the email link. I don't know. Or get Jill to do it. And she gets her $1,000 for free. Okay. It doesn't mean she gets a free $1,000. Just the processing on $1,000. Okay. So the quantity, the description. The description is really, I mean, mine look like this. TWC/OMOI. Most people would be like, what is that? Otherwise, time-wise combat oily moisturizer. In the beginning, you're going to write a lot. You don't have to. It's for you. Okay, and then the price of the item, and then the next line where it says amount is so you can multiply. So if they bought two of them, then you do two of them, so then it costs more. Okay, it's pretty simple. I tend to actually put the amount here, and I do the discounts here if I'm doing a sale or whatever, -$2, -$5, whatever. Okay, then you total it all up. The total goes in the subtotal spot. The subtotal is what you use to calculate your GST. We're all in Alberta here, unless you're not, sorry. But the people who are in Alberta, it's times 0.05. So take the subtotal times 0.05 and put it in the GST spot. If you are sending to someone out of the province, you need to figure out their PST as well and charge them that. If you took off any discounts, that goes in the adjustments. So you go minus $12 or minus $5 or whatever you took off. And then shipping. This is often asked of me, what should we charge for shipping? Well, you pay about $12 per order to get delivered to your house and about $9 to direct ship it anywhere in Canada once you place your first activating order. But I personally prefer to charge everybody $2. It just evens it all out. There's always extra so that I can drop ship. I do drop ship a lot. I send a lot to even Northwest Edmonton or Edmonton. Of course I drop ship to Edmonton. Northwest Calgary because it's too far for me to drive. So I just send it. Okay. So once you're active, you've placed your first order. As long as you're in your active period, you can direct ship to people. Okay. But I just charge everybody $2. You don't have to. It's not the law. But then that way you can basically even out. You can offer free shipping. You can offer free shipping on orders of over $50 and charge $2 on the rest. It's up to you. It's totally up to you. Okay. All right. Now, and then you just total it up. At the bottom, this part at the bottom here where it says independent beauty consultant and the number, I don't know why it has both the number and then it says the independent beauty consultant's merchant number. Your number is your Mary Kay number, like TN2985. I've never really understood that. So if somebody on Periscope knows, feel free to let me know. And then your phone number and your email address. Okay. The customer gets the pink one. That's hers. The green one is for your taxes. And the white one goes stapled to the back of your customer profile when you're done ordering.
The stuff at the back, you just throw it out.
I just throw it out. Okay, this is basically, you can give this to her as well. It basically is just the buyer's right to cancel her order. And then it's a cancellation form. According to direct sales laws, we have to have these on there. That's all.
Pink is okay. Customer.
Does it pink is customer. There? It does. Yeah, it says right here. It says in customer copy. Okay, and in income envelope copy and independent beauty consultant copy. Cool? Good. Okay. So pass those back this way. I'm going to keep one out so that I can sort of do a demo. I'll keep the lipsticked one out. The other things in your kit that we're not going to touch too much on today. You have combo to oily time-wise in the, William, the returns are on a different form. You just do those online. That's not this part. That's not for returns, okay? Honestly, when a customer returns something, I write in Sharpie on the bottle that Jen, 403-922, whatever, and then I stick it in my bag and I do a big return all at once online. And I can cover returns, but there is a video on how to do it on the new Transformers thing. These samples of combo to oily. Yes, you can give these away. However, yes, the consultant number is only important for returns. Sorry, William's asking me a question here. The consultant number is only important for returns if you quit and she needs the receipt. But she only needs the little pink slip for that. So that's why you need the consultant number on there. Otherwise, she returns through you. But they are guaranteed. So that's the nice thing. You can say that to your customers too. Even if I quit and you still don't like this product, you can return it to the company as long as you have your pink receipt. Okay? Don't hand these all out willy-nilly. They cost you money, okay? And they're designed because these are combo to oily, and you have full-size normal to dry. So you don't want to be giving everybody normal to dry. If you gave me normal to dry cleanser, I would hate you, and I would not buy it because I am oily, super oily, and I would cry, okay? So don't do that. Use these for that. That's why it's in there, okay? These are your beauty cards. We can go through these in a minute. You have trays and mirrors. I'm going to pretend like you guys don't know how to do this, but you probably do. So we're just going to just, it's Mary Kay for Dummies. Take it out. You do not need to carry this. I don't know how rough you would have to be on your mirrors. Please peel this off. You may think that that's a stupid thing to do. Some people forget. Linda Rose, for example, our president, did a 10-show week to prove that anybody could do a 10-show week and didn't take them off. And all of her customers were like, wow, your mirrors really suck because they were all wibbly wobbly. So peel off the little plastic layer. Leave it on there. It's quite satisfying for you. And it pops in like this. And then your little tray. And you guys are so lucky. Like, I can't even tell you. We had styrofoam trays. They did not have pretty little numbers on them. So then you had to count that your customer knew the difference between right and left, which they do not. So you'd be like, your bottom right-hand corner and your bottom left-hand corner. And then one day somebody put lip gloss all over her face because she started at the bottom left-hand side instead of the bottom right-hand side. So these have numbers on them. You put them in the tray, and then you put the things in. The more you have, then the more you put them in the order that you're putting them on, okay? So then at a party, you can say, everybody scoop out from number 5. Keep them all the same. And always use them the same, no matter what. And it will, then you won't have to reinvent it and think about it later. What the heck do I do? So these are your trays. Please, for the love of all that is holy, do not wash these and reuse them because that is gross. Gross! Don't do them. Okay? They're dirt cheap. They're $3 for 60, I think. Like, oh my God. Okay, you can recycle these. Just give them a rinse and chuck them into your recycling bin. Do not hand somebody some disgusting dog-haired, fingerprinted. Oh, I messed it for you. Gross. Gross. There are lots of people who do it. Don't do it. That's disgusting. Okay, sanitized is good. I like to take these little zippy bags, and then you put your order form in here. And you put your profile card in here, and you put a pen in here, and your cotton pads, and your applicators, and a mascara wand, and a cloth, and maybe a little hairband, and your mirror, and look at that. You have enough to do 5 people right away. So if you have a facial for 2 people, you just grab 2 of these bags. If you have 5 people, you grab all 5. You will collect more mirrors as your life goes on. I don't know how. I have like 500. A lot of times people will quit and go, do you want my stuff? Sure. And then I end up with all these extra things. They are available. You can purchase them for $6 each, and you do get some extras with your first orders, okay? But they make it really, really easy for you. If you don't like the zippy bags for that, then use the zippy bags. I use these for my lip glosses. I use them for all my demos because you can see through them. My kids have these as their pencil cases in school. So all their pencil crayons are in one and all their markers are in the other. They're fantastic. They're really, really durable, really great. Because your mirrors don't, they can stay in there by themselves, by their lonely little self. But I don't know about you, but if I'm not organized for an appointment, I won't make the appointment. So then I don't have to stress about it. If she calls me and says, hey, can we meet tomorrow? No problem. I don't have to think, oh my God, do I have enough mascara wands? Do I have enough this? Do I have enough that? I know I have enough supplies for 30 people downstairs. And I actually use freezer bags. I use like medium-sized freezer bags from the dollar store, and I just pop them all in there because I don't like to zip things closed. It's like a thing. So I just keep them all lined up in an IKEA box, and they're all there, and I can just go, oh, I have a party of 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Grab all 6 and go. Okay? Cool? Just makes life just, I'm a big believer in easy. Okay. These cleansing cloths as well. Please. I know you won't reuse them, but there's lots of people out there that feel the need because these are disposable, and I get that they're disposable, but then they use white face cloths, and I just think, and then they have to go home, and they have to bleach them, and they have to reuse them and make sure they're dry, and I just think, how are you seeing 30 faces a month if that's what you have to do? You're not. You're seeing 3, and you're saying to yourself that you're doing a great thing, but you're not. Okay? Sorry. If that's you, don't do that. So the disposable face cloths are amazing. If you are frugal like me, I cut these in half because there is a lot of cloth. Okay, so I cut them in half, and I get 60 out of it. Actually, my daughter cuts them in half because it's one of her jobs.
It's true. So you do have 4 mirrors in your kit that's designed that way. They don't give you a ton of mirrors because they don't want you freaking out and thinking you have to do a 12-person party. You don't. A Mary Kay party is smaller than this. At the kitchen table. It's designed to be at the kitchen table. The magic happens at the kitchen table. Do you know that Mary Kay first heard about our skincare way before it was our skincare at a kitchen? She was selling pots and pans and Stanley Home products at a party, and everybody went in the kitchen. They were all like, and she thought they were selling drugs. They weren't. They were selling skincare in pill bottles. So
So one of the ladies, the lady who owned the house, her dad used to be, you guys know this story? Her dad used to be a taxidermist. And he discovered that the back of his hands always were softer than his face. They always looked better because of the products in the tanning agents. And so his daughter thought, well, if that's true, then it must be a great skincare. So she took it and sort of kitchen sink doctored it up. I'm sure she added other weird things and perfume and Vaseline or whatever to create her own little formulas and like sold them in baby food jars and pill containers back and forth. And Mary Kay bought them for years. And then when this woman died, she bought the rights to the skincare ingredients. She bought it from the family and then created her own for a long time until she decided to start her own company. They took it to chemists after that. Don't worry. Our Mary Kay products are not made in a bathtub. You know, and then we're probably not anywhere near what the products were like then, but it's just kind of an interesting story about how it evolved. And it all came because she was in direct sales in another company and then saw this lady in the kitchen. Okay. Satin hand set is in your kit. You know, you guys know satin hands is amazing. You will always sell satin hands. I don't care who you are. You can sell satin hands. You could be like this. This is my satin hands. And you would sell it. Wouldn't matter. Okay. Microdermabrasion, those of you who signed up this month, you get a free microdermabrasion in there, and then you get 2 CC creams. Okay, light to medium, medium to deep. Easy. Okay, if you're finding you don't have a lot of medium to deep customers, guess what this is also good for? Your legs. It's like a pantyhose in a bottle. Mm-hmm. Covers all the veins and the issues. Yeah, it's pretty amazing. If you search through our group or just tag Chris Hunt, she did one where she's got like her legs two side by side that you can share even, and people just put those on. It doesn't transfer. No, it's awesome. Once you set it, like it has to wait a few minutes to dry and then it's fine. I wore it with a white dress once. It's totally fine. Okay?
Someone used it to cover tattoos.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Yeah. Like just because it's so creamy, so it's easy to put on all over and you don't have to worry about it the same way. So CC cream is really, really great. Here's how you're gonna do your appointment. Are we spent? Are you good? You guys are all like, okay.
You're the one doing all the talking.
Okay. I know, right?
Water break. Do you find the peach sells more than the fragrance free or
yes. The... Yes. I sell more peach than fragrance free. I could not touch the peach in my first 2 years of business. Because okay, so my friend, we were drinking in college. It was a birthday party. She got one of those big, huge things of peach. No, peach bubble bath. And she's like, here, Carol, smell it. And then went, oh, and I aspirated it. I got it stuck in my lungs. I had to go to the hospital. I was in the hospital for 2 days.
With
instead of water on the lung, peach bubble bath on the lung.
No,
it's quite funny now, but then every time I sneeze, bubbles would come out. It was not so good. And I couldn't look at peaches for a really long time. And my friends would be like, millions of peaches. Yeah, jerks.
Oh, yeah.
Jerks. It was really bad. So, yeah, I would cough and, like, bubbles. That was a lot of hearts on that one. Yeah.
Is that peach or...
This is fragrance-free because it's going to be more universally appealing. Here's what I recommend for you. Get the you have the fragrance-free. Buy yourself for your demo kit one bottle, not the whole thing. You don't need the whole scrub and everything else, just of the lotion of the peach. And then offer the choice at the end. So you guys know how to use satin hands? Okay. We're not actually going to do it, but we can do it at the sink later. This is the first thing you do. You don't have to have an appointment to do this. I mean, you're not going to... like molest people on the street. That's not what I mean. At least you not throw people that, no, you're trying the satin hands, damn it. Okay, you can do this in an office really, really easily. You can do this with your friends and family. You don't have to sit down. They don't have to wash their face, anything like that, right? It's very easy to go wash your hands at the sink. You can stick this in the bathroom at a family get-together. You can write number one, number two, number three on it and like let them figure it out, whatever. First step, so they wet their hands a little bit. Okay, with water, and they put a tiny little bit of the hand softener on here. This is a very, this is one of those petroleum-based sort of ingredients where it's, like, really thick and gooey. This is the closest we have to our original moisturizer in 1963.
Gross.
What's that called?
This is the fragrance-free hand softener, and it's always going to be fragrance-free in this step. So it always will be the same in the fragrance-free or the peach or whatever. a little bit of water, put this on. What this does is it's going to provide a barrier protection, and it's going to soften up the dead skin cells so they can be removed. And you just say it like that. This is going to provide a barrier protection and soften up the dead skin cells so they can be removed. Just a minute, they're writing things down. Dead skin cells so they can be removed. Teresa's like, what? Wait. Something was said. Okay. So soften up your dead skin cells so they can be removed. And then I say, what is the difference between a dead skin cell and an alive skin cell? Most people will go, one's alive. Yeah. You cannot bring a dead skin cell back to life. It's dead. It be dead. There is no second coming of the skin cell. There is no resurrection of the skin cell. There is no zombie skin cells walking around. They're dead. And the problem with dead skin cells is they act as a barrier and they don't allow moisture to penetrate. So it doesn't matter how much you're moisturizing if you don't get rid of the dead skin cells, because they just are like the bouncers at the bar that won't let you in. So I say it just like that, you guys, every time. Every time. Make them laugh and they will buy. There are no zombie skin cells. No zombie skin cells. So we want to get rid of the skin cells. So that's while they're doing this, you're talking. Okay, you want them to have activity while they're doing this. So they're wiping this stuff on, and then that way they're not like, ew, this feels really weird, because they're busy listening to you. But it's supposed to feel really weird. That's the whole point. Their hands are still wet. One pump of this. This is the scrub. This is going to gently remove the dead skin cells. This is the scrub. It's going to gently remove the dead skin cells. This is the scrub. Romance your product. Don't do that creepy. Just love it. Molest it. Okay, so one pump in everybody's hands. They're scrubbing. Okay, then they rinse and dry. Have paper towels handy for them, or a hostess cloth or whatever, like a pair. Don't use these for that. That goes way too fast. And then when they dry off, if you have the peach, you can offer them the choice. If not, you just give them the fragrance free. And just a little bit. This is going to hydrate your hands for 24 hours. I tend to not use the word moisturize because I don't like the word moist. So hydrate. This is going to hydrate your hands for 24 hours. It lasts through 7 hand washings. Yeah. They say that. Oh, and I say these make really great gifts. So if you know anybody for a birthday or anniversary or whatever, great gifts for men, great gifts for women. Guys love this stuff. Mm-hmm. They love satin hands. True story.
My man does.
Mm-hmm.
He works in an oil shop. Sorry.
Yeah.
I haven't actually heard of that stuff, so I'm not excited to go home.
Oh, yeah, it's good.
I'm just like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
Not really crappy.
I have people who use this, and I use this in the shower. Okay, on your feet, one of my friend who lives two doors down calls it sex for the feet, because it's just like the best. The scrub and the lotion are the best. This is, yeah, like it lasts through hand washings. It's great for nurses especially because they're washing their hands a lot. They need to hydrate. You can use this instead of soap in the bathroom because it does have a cleanser in it as well. So instead of anything else, you don't always have to put this first step on because a lot of people will be like, oh, that's a lot of steps. You don't have to put this on. You can also put this step on while you're like just before bed on your feet or your hands to go before you go to bed or your legs. Like, yeah, I don't know about you, but I get crocodile legs, like something fierce. I just put this all over and then go to bed. Okay?
Eczema too.
Yes, a lot. Mm-hmm. Babies and eczema
I
too. Emollient
cream because my friend didn't like mm-hmm. a rose smell, so I just yes.
like favor
that.
Yeah, the emollient cream and this are the same.
Just
yeah. This is called the fragrance free hand softener. If you want to buy this separate, this is called the extra emollient night cream on our order forms, but it has a rose smell to it. Has a fragrance added. And we're not going to get rid of that smell because it's been around for like 30 years and people would kill us. Like, anytime it comes out as a Christmas gift set, they're like, ah, they lose their minds.
It's so called what on the
It's order? Called Extra Emollient Night Cream.
Extra Emollient Night Cream.
But it's $23? $23 by itself, and yet this whole set's $51.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So it's a pretty good deal. You cannot buy the scrub separately. You can buy the lotion separately, and you can buy a different version of this separately, but you can't buy the scrub separately, and they do that on purpose so that you use it all together. It is our only set that's like that, though. We don't have any other set that you can't buy like that. And I do say that to people, and I hold it just like this, you guys. Romance your product. You don't have a lot to romance. You only have a few things, so it's really easy.
So you can put the softener on without washing it off.
Yes.
Essentially, when you do the whole system, you're washing it off.
Yes, but otherwise you can just leave
otherwise
this on.
It's just like a moisturizer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Intense moisturizer. You know when your kids get really bad chapped lips or they rub themselves raw or whatever? That. Okay.
So I could use that on my lips right now where it feels like I've got nothing but dead.
Yeah, until you have satin lips. Satin
I was just going to ask you, is that what satin lips do?
Yeah,
I satin lips is awesome.
Oh, yeah. That's so right. Oh, good. So we'll go through yours after we go through the basic one, and I'll tell them what to get to add to their kits. Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Satin lips is the way to go. But right now, you can totally do this. It's just a little thicker. Okay? So satin hands. What's the first thing you do when you get back to the table? Write it down on their wish list. How do your hands feel? Great, right? Do you want that on your wish list in peach or in fragrance free? If they ask what's the peach like, it smells exactly like fuzzy peach candies. And you all went, oh, okay, that's what they say. So you don't even have to have it, but it's great if you do. What's the peach sound? I'm not like, oh, it smells exactly like fuzzy peach candies. Oh, okay. Especially right at Halloween.
Lotion samplers, too.
Yes. Yeah, the little lotion samplers are great, too. Like, I just carry the mini one in my kit because otherwise my kit's so big, right? Mm. So you can get the minis or you can get the big ones. The mini satin hands are available in Section 2. They don't count as one of your first retail orders. They're samples, but they are $7 for 12 of them. Right, 12?
It's yeah. A fair size. Like,
yeah.
So, yeah, that's
perfect
like
a purse.
They're big,
yeah.
I have it in my purse right
then now. People would do back lips for purse size satin hands. So, they're really great gifts. They're really great incentives, things like that. And you can just keep them in there. Remember that time that things just flew down the stairs? Those of you who are not in our studio audience,
I'm grateful for the call.
An exercise ball just flew down the stairs and almost took out three consultants. Welcome to Carol's new consultant training. Okay, so fragrance-free satin hands. Everybody's clear on this one?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, $50, $51 right away, $25.50 in your pocket. For every single one you sell, if you, statistics say, if you show 30 people this, 15 will buy. If you just get 30 people to wash their hands, you don't even have to do the rest. It's 30 people. I'm coming over. And with your friends, you're like, I'm coming over. Coming over. We're washing your hands. Am I dirty? Yes, you are. We're doing it. Okay? They will love it. They do. It's been a bestseller. It's one of our most seasoned products. Makes a great Christmas present. Makes a great teacher's gift. These are great. I just watched the video today, too, and she says to bag it up, you take, like, for a gift basket, you take your bag and you just kind of fold it down like this several times and then tuck the handles in and then put it in here like that so that you can see it and then wrap up that. So you get this cute little bag. So that was really cute too. And if you offer gift wrapping services to things like that, you're going to sell these. Like how many moms are like, I do not know what to get Auntie Linda or my mother-in-law. Okay. Satin hands.
So it comes in that bag.
It comes in this beautiful little bag. Easy peasy. You can tie a big bow on that and you're done. Or you can bag it up inside one of those like basket bags and throw a few fuzzy peach candies in if it's, you know, at Halloween right now, that's the perfect time to buy those little mini ones or steal them from your kids' Halloween bags. And then, you know, bag it up with a cute little package of those in there. That's a great little gift idea. Okay? Good? Everybody's clear on that? That's easy. Then we go back to the table. And you have cleanser in one part of your tray and moisturizer in the other. You don't have to use the trays when this is all the freaking product you have because you can put it right into your hands. Okay, so you don't have to use the trays if you don't want to. But for all intents and purposes, we're going to say that we are using the trays. You put a little bit of the 3-in-1 cleanser, fingernail size amount. Fingernail. Okay, not a ton. You know, child of mine. You don't need a lot. You're going to wet the cloth. And you're going to hand it to her. You're going to say this. I want you to show me your loser fingers. Okay? These are the two fingers that you should not touch your face with ever, because they are stronger than the rest of your hand. And they will cause you to...
Hi.
Hi. You almost took out all of us with that ball. Can you not do that again? Yeah, stupid kid. Go upstairs. I don't know. Daddy took them. Life's hard. Bye. Lose your fingers. These are your strongest fingers. They're 7 times stronger than the rest of your fingers. So you don't want her pulling and tugging at her skin. She's going to get saggy, baggy panty face. This is how I got known for the big girl panties, because I always would carry a really large pair of granny panties in my bag and pull them out and say, these used to be a size small thong from Licenza. And then I pulled and tugged at them so much that now they're this big. It's a very easy tactic, so I strongly recommend it. You can go to the bargain store or whatever. Dollarama even has great big girl panties. Get some humongous granny panties, polka dots or whatever, and just be like, these were a size small. Then I kept pulling, because your skin isn't elastic and your skull isn't getting any bigger. So what happens is when you pull and tug at your skin and it's an elastic, the less you take care of it and the more you pull and tug at it, the bigger your skin gets, which equals sagging, which equals wrinkles. Saggy baggy panty face. It's like my patented term. Loser fingers is also a patented Carol Thompson term. You can give me credit for that when you talk about it. Okay? So you're going to tell her that, then you say wet your face with the cloth. Just moisten it. You're not going to scrub. You're just going to gently wet your face, scoop up your cleanser. That's in spot number one, if this is your basic kit, spot number one. And you're going to go up like this, and you do it right with her, up, and then across on your forehead, and down on your nose and chin. So up on your cheeks, outside 3 fingers only, up on your cheeks, across on your forehead, and down on your nose and chin. I could do this in my sleep. Okay? The reason we go up is what? And you ask her that. Why do you think we go up? Do you guys know?
Because of the hairs on our face.
Yes, because we have little hairs on our face. They act like little shingles on a roof. You want to lift those up to get into them. Do this. Ready? Everybody do it with me. This. You want to lift those up. They act like little shingles. You want to lift those up. The more that you can visualize with her, the better. So don't just say it. Do it. Lift those up. Get into that. But if you go in circles, you're taking that hair follicle and you're irritating the crap out of it. It's going in circles. The root gets bigger, which equals more room for bacteria, which equals pimples and more free radicals getting in and making you older. So when the skincare companies tell you to go in circles with cleanser, what they're actually doing is saying to you, I want to sell you more things as you get older. Mary Kay doesn't do that. And they really don't. And now you gain their trust.
So you don't need to be vigorously going like gently. This. It's just
gentle, 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 gentle.
That's it.
That's it. No scrubby scrub.
So with the little brush that spins, then
the brush that spins is not pushing the hairs the same way your finger is. Okay. This is a lot stronger than your brush. So your brush, it doesn't actually move the hairs at all. It's just on the outside. So it's going to gently lift, but it doesn't stress them right out the way that you are when you're doing this. Because your fingers are a lot stronger than that SkinVigorate brush. Okay. Yeah. Same as the jackhammer ones, those SkinVigorate brushes, not our line, but the ones that are like, those are not good for your skin. If they vibrate you, they will age you. And then they can sell you more crap. That's the way they work. But the thing about Mary Kay, and I do say this to my customers, the thing about Mary Kay is that their mission is to make us look younger so we sell more. So they're going to actually teach us how to take care of our skin, not the wrong way. And therefore, I'm teaching you that. Say these things. Mimic these things. They are well-known selling tactics, but they're not just tricks because they're true. So you're just telling her these things. Okay? The reason that Mary Kay does that is so that we look younger. And therefore, you get to look younger. So these have little beads in them. And as she's cleaning, you're going to say, these have little beads in them. They are round, biodegradable beads that won't clog your pores, but that will gently exfoliate your skin every day. Then you ask her, why do we want to exfoliate and get rid of dead skin? She knows. She just did it at the sink so that the moisturizer can penetrate. Right. We want to get rid of dead skin so that all the good ingredients that you're putting on with your moisturizer can actually get down there. Because you can buy the most expensive serums in the world, but if you have dead skin on your face, they can't get in. I say that. And then she gets it. Then she takes it back off again with the cloth. And I say to her, this is a 3-in-1 cleanser. It has 3 things that it does. It cleanses, it tones, and it exfoliates. So it's also going to shrink and tighten your pores. And restore the pH balance of your skin.
Are there videos about this?
Yes. On the new Transformers group, there's a whole thing on how to do a facial with just your kit. Yeah. So this
with
is
all
just
these things you're saying.
Yeah. Everything that I'm saying. Because I say the same thing at every appointment. Yeah. Like,
online, there's also like product pages that are really good. Like if you're going to a party and you know somebody needs something in particular, you can just look it up and it gives you like just the bullet points.
Exactly. Yeah. You used to have this. I found this the other day. You used to have this. It was like your consultant guide. And then when the new product came out, there was nothing. But online, oh, see, that's not a new product. That's gone now, that product that I opened up to. So is that. Okay. So you would go to, on MKOC, under the product fact sheets, everything is there. But you don't need to know every single detail. Because you may know things and be poor.
It's nice to reference if someone's asking you about something particular or something.
Yeah, exactly. If somebody's like, what does CRMC do? And you're like, I don't know. But you know what's awesome about Mary Kay is they have all these sheets for us. Let's look it up together. And then you do, then you're fine, okay? But most of the time, like when you're doing your basics, like your basic stuff, you don't need to know that. Just memorize the stuff I tell you. Honestly.
The soy and gluten-free allergy stuff though is on there too.
Yes, that's right.
So people have like serious allergies.
Yeah, well, like me, I'm celiac. I can't use anything with gluten in it. I thought I could get away with it. I cannot. So I had to give up my serum seed. Sad face. So this is really, like, just really memorize those key things. Make them laugh. Give them something interesting to think about because they're going to be more likely to trust you and buy from you. If you can make them laugh, they're more likely to like you. You want to up your eye likability factor. You're not really selling Mary Kay. You're selling you. You're just selling yourself. Okay? Not like that. You can make more money than you can on the street. Okay? And you can keep doing it even when everything's down here. All right?
So I have a question. Mm-hmm. Can they put the cleanser on when they have makeup on, like at a party?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Because I was watching the video and they're all wearing makeup.
Yeah, it dissolves your foundation. And it's designed, if somebody has a little bit of foundation left over, just say it's designed
so
to work with your Mary Kay foundation.
To, like, wash their
They're washing their makeup off. Yeah. But you're going to give it back to them because you have CC cream. So you're going to give them foundation again. And you say to them, don't worry, I'm not going to let you walk out naked. Yeah. So 3-in-1 cleanser, up, cross and down. Okay. 3 things in one. Next thing you say to her is what?
Would you like me to put this on your wish list?
That's right. How does your skin feel? Great. Okay, she's going to touch her face. It's natural. How does it feel? Great. And then, is this going on your wish list? Yes, like this. And you do it like this. Is this going on your wish list? She will do this. It's like a law. Bobbleheads, okay? They do it, okay? 3-in-1 cleanser. Then your moisturizer. 12 hours of hydration. On your face, you give it to her, up, across, and down, same direction. Give it to her fast. That's what she said. Give it to her fast. Because if her skin's feeling really dry, she's going to judge that based on her cleanser, not based on how fast she needs moisturizer, right? So if you're like talking and talking and talking and her skin is getting, because the cleanser does that, then she's not going to love you, all right? So give it to her really, really fast. You can talk about it afterwards.
How many hours, sorry?
This is 12 hours of hydration. That's my dog, who's like, dude, let me in. So just a little bit of moisturizer, up, across, and down, pea-sized amount, okay? And you're going to hydrate your skin. Stay away from the eye area. We do have an eye cream for that. Just say that. Stay away from the eye area. We have an eye cream for that. I don't have it with me today, but at your follow-up appointment, you can try it.
What was the name of that eye cream?
Firming. Eye cream. Yeah. We have 2, but most people
have
firming
eye cream. Different eye things. So
yes, I know. I know. Works. And we're going to keep it really simple. That's why Mary Kay kept their kit really simple. It's really important that they do so that you're not overwhelmed. Our kit used to be insane. And then we had a lot of people quitting because they just couldn't figure it out. So just 30 faces with this will make everything else fine. Okay? 30 faces. You're going to wash their hands, wash their face, and leave. Bye. Okay, now you even get to give them some skin, some foundation. You didn't before. They never used to be CC cream before. Stop it, dog. Anna, please let Swayze in and try and get him to our room. Please.
Help.
I'm very sorry if you get mauled by my large dog. Not really mauled. He just will love on you.
I was going to say, okay. By the sounds of it, it's more like love.
It's love. Yeah. Hi, yeah. Swayze. Okay, close the door. Oh, Sabrina can pop that close. There we go. For real, die. It's cold out there. Okay, go to bed. Go to bed. Bed.
Baby.
Sorry.
She's like, forget it. There's people around.
Okay, just lead him up, honey. Okay, sorry, those of you on Periscope. We have bags everywhere. He'll calm down in a second. So now you can give her CC cream. Most people, like everyone at this table, would be light to medium. Okay? If you're in doubt, go medium to deep. If you get it wrong, you can layer the other one over top. You'll be okay. Okay? So just give her a one pump of CC cream. She's going to put makeup goes down. Keep her eye makeup on for her first appointment. This is the easy peasy skincare appointment. This is not the huge makeup appointment. Keep her eye makeup on. Keep everything else on. She doesn't need to take it off. You don't even have eye makeup remover. So don't worry about it. You don't have to know a darn thing about eyeshadow yet. Just, you can say, wash your face and put your moisturizer on, right? Everybody say that. Wash your face.
Put your moisturizer on.
How does your skin feel?
Great.
And then they say, great. And then you say, would you like this on your wish list? What?
I'm just looking for the
We don't have them. Daddy took them with him to Ban. Too bad. Deal with your life. Okay, so that's it. If they want to try microdermabrasion, because some of you have this in your kit and some of you don't, then you give a tiny little amount and they can do it with a wet side of their nose. They can do one side of their nose, wipe it off, and put the next gel on. Okay? The instructions are on here. The description is on here. Easy pieces. It's the first thing I ever bought.
It's amazing. I love that. I bought it too, and then I sold three just by talking to my friends about it because I was so excited on life about it, and I only did half my dose.
That's right. Enthusiasm sells. You don't have to know anything.
I love it because they're like, what's your name? And I'm like, this, and then they all bought it at $60.
That's right.
Talking. I was like, you want to try it first? Like, no,
they can try it on their elbow for crying out loud. So if you're at the office or whatever, little bit of water on their back of their... Oh, I hit myself with that. Little bit of water, elbow, and then we rinse it off. That's the little round beads. They are round, so they're not jagged, and they cut your pores because cut pores equal more free radicals and more bacteria, which equals pimples and wrinkles. Little bit scrub.
If you're doing this comes before your moisturizer.
Yeah,
right?
Typically you would do this in between. But it doesn't matter, honestly, Krista, if you've already done cleanser and moisturizer and you're like, oh, did you want to try microdermabrasion? Totally fine.
Just do
that little tiny bit that they don't have moisturizer on, they can stick some moisturizer on over top.
Mm-hmm.
They're fine. Okay? So just a little bit of scrub, scrubby, scrub, scrub. They can use their index finger for this. They can go in circles for this because this is a once a week thing. It's not every single day, twice a day. Have you all tried this yet?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. If you haven't, try it. It's worth it.
And there's probably a tutorial online.
True
story. How to do a whole
You really
face.
Just, honestly, a full face is like this. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Stay away from the eyes. Rinse it off. That's it. It's just taking off the dead skin. Then when your skin is washed, then the pore minimizer can go on. This can be used twice a day, every single day, right after your cleanser. So if you have larger pores, you can use this every single day. Yeah. The old microdermabrasion used to use this only after you scrubbed, but now they've added the pore minimizer in. It is available separately, but they've added the pore minimizer in so that you can use it every single day right after your cleanser. It is amazing. The results I've seen are out of this world, so use it. Your kit is there for you guys to use too. You can't sell anything if you're not excited about it, so it's okay to use your cleanser out of your kit. It's okay to use your CC cream. Just don't spin in it. I'm pretty sure you were thinking about that. But honestly, you're expected to do that, so use it. Because you can't sell what you're not excited about.
Can I ask you a question about this SPF day cream?
Yes.
So if somebody says, well, if I have this, why do I need the SPF day cream? Because it has SPF in it.
This does not. This is available separately. The reason that we have the day solution is not just for the SPF properties. There's a collagen booster in it, so it's going to immediately plump up and fine lines and wrinkles. It goes into your cellular level and plumps up those skin cells and increases collagen within there so that it's over time going to do that. It is a serum. It's very light, So it's designed to penetrate past the dead skin layers most of us have from 25 to 45 years old. We have probably 13 layers of dead skin that's useless on our face, not counting the dead skin we need. 13 layers. That means we need a really thin formula to get right down there. And that's what the Day Solution does. It also has a luminizer and a brightener in it. And it helps with redness and overall complexion. It's fantastic. So it's not just for the SPF properties. It's for everything else. A lot of people will use both. They use the Day Solution and the Age Friendly Moisturizer with SPF.
Okay.
Okay. But as well, I don't tend to love selling the Age Friendly Moisturizer with SPF because why do you need SPF at night?
So
with the Miracle Set, it goes like this. When you have the full kit with the Miracle Set, it's cleanser first, then either day or night solution, depending if it is day or night, and then your moisturizer. The Day Solution is your anti-aging serum that has the SPF. The Night Solution is an anti-aging serum that has vitamins that help rebuild your skin while you sleep. They do not give two craps what the vitamins are. You could say they're vitamin blah, 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 and they'd be like, oh, good. They don't know. They don't care. If somebody asks you for more specific details, that's when you go to the consultant guide on MKOC and look it up. But you don't need it. You honestly do not need to know all those ingredients, okay? So don't stress about them. Make it your mission to look at one product a day. That's not 50. You're not making a big binder of every single product and then conning yourself, because this is what happens. We con ourselves into thinking we're working when we're not. That's what you're doing, okay? So don't do that. Look at one new product a day. Get to know one new product a day. Maybe on every order one thing for yourself or your kit that you want to try. That's it. Or borrow something from one of us to try. Even complexion mask, dark spot roller, whatever. Borrow something. Because we all have them, right? And you can try them out. If you don't know if people like it, go on the group and say, hey, what do you guys think of this? I have a customer asking. 72 people will answer. Okay? There are products some of us don't like, and there are lots of products we do. These are guaranteed. Microdermabrasion. There's nobody who doesn't like microdermabrasion. I don't think I've ever returned a microdermabrasion because everybody loves it. Like, it's amazing.
Signed up for that.
Yeah, exactly. It's the first product I ever bought. I got conned into going to a Mary Kay dinner and makeover, and I was never one to take my makeup off in front of people. Like, that was terrifying. They made me do it, and then I had really flaky skin on my nose, and she gave me a tiny little pea-sized amount to do one side of my nose, and I was like, you better give me some more, or I'm a riot, because I do not appreciate this. I had flaky on one side and nothing on the other, and I bought the full Miracle Set and full microdermabrasion that day forward. So it's my favorite product ever. It's well worth investing the time to try it and to show it to people at your appointments. But don't worry about the order, because this goes on normally in place of cleanser once a week.
Oh, okay.
Does that make it easy?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And with the cleanser, I know people will ask this because I'm thinking mm-hmm. it. Can you use the cleanser twice a day, or do you recommend
yes.
it once a day?
Twice a day, morning and night.
Okay.
You want to wash your face in the morning. Your oils in your skin are all working up. So your skin cells are working really, really hard to purge all that junk out. And then if you don't wash it and you just rinse it in the shower or do nothing, it just goes right back in. Every day that you don't wash your face before bed, you age 7 times faster. Mm-hmm. It's actually 3 to 7 days depending on your ethnicity. But because we're all white, 7 days.
That's
terrifying. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. There's hope. I didn't wash my face till I was 28. And I'm 40, so you're okay. Okay? It's totally fine. You're fine. I wish I'd done it sooner, but you're fine. Okay, CC cream, complexion corrector. It has a ton of different things in it that are easy to memorize. There's 11 steps. I don't even know what all the 11 things that CC cream does. No one's ever asked me. This is a complexion corrector. It's skincare and foundation in one. Can you get excited about that? And they are. That's it.
And it's amazing.
It is. And you can use this as a primer for your foundation too. So mm-hmm. if you want to use this all over and then just use a little bit of extra foundation where you need a little extra coverage, you can. If you are at an appointment and you do not know what shade of foundation that person is, text me or text Jill or text Kiro or put it on the group, her picture, and say, help. Someone will help you. Okay? We will get it pretty right most of the time. Okay, tell us if she tans or burns, and send us a picture. I'm not teaching you about foundation today. You do not need to know it. There's a guarantee policy for a freaking reason. Okay, try not to pick it out of the catalog. You will cry. You will have a bad time. just text us a picture, okay? If I'm not around and you text me and I don't answer right away, I'm not ignoring that. I will never ignore that. So it just means that I'm in an appointment or I have my phone on Do Not Disturb, like right now. So you can put it on the group too and somebody will answer you, okay? Easy, all right? So CC Cream, leave her eyeshadow on. Don't do makeup yet, okay? Don't do it unless she insists that she needs makeup yet. Book her for her customized glamour appointment. And they know that sounds terrifying. Pull out your catalog, or your catalog. Pull out your booking tools after you've closed the sale. I'm going to come back to closing the sale. Pull out your agenda, and you're going to book her. Your customized glamour appointment just means you're going to use one of these three cards. That's it. Every face I saw for my first 100 faces did one of these cards. That's it. These are easy. They're designed for you. They're made by makeup artists. Why are you better? You're not. We're not. Use these. Okay? Not only do they help you with your recruiting, but they also help you with your sales. And they help you with your inventory. Because now you don't have to carry 27 eyeshadows. You only have to carry the ones on this card. You only have to carry the lipsticks on this card. You only have to carry the eyeshadows or the blushes on this card. Nothing else. It makes it pretty easy, right? There's no Kohl on here. You don't have to worry about having 12 Kohls. They're here, okay? Makes it really easy. It's just going to customize it for you. It's awesome. Don't give everything away at the first appointment. Don't give it away. They're not going to buy the milk or whatever. Yeah, okay? Honestly, so you're going to close the sale. I'm going to go through that. Then you're going to pull out your agenda and you're going to say, I have to see you for your next appointment. I have to see you for your next appointment. Oh. I know. But you're going to book it so far in advance that you've already gotten your mascara. You've already done your first 30 faces based on this. So now you are going to have a few extra things to show her too. And she's going to be happy about that. So even if she doesn't wear makeup, you're going to say, well, that's okay. I'm going to have more skincare to show you at our next appointment. Because I'll have the rest of the miracle set. I'll have different things. Okay? You don't, if you can read, which I hope you can, you're going to have a really bad time in this business if you can't read. I'm sure there's some people out there that have succeeded and are doing inspirational speeches right now about how they did Mary Kay and they couldn't read. Most of us can read. It says right here, okay? So, have you looked at these?
No.
Okay, here, you guys share. They're labeled. 1, 2, 3.
I just did.
Okay, mm-hmm. It says where to put 1, 2, and 3. Not hard.
Thank you, Mary Kay.
Exactly. Okay, the blush goes on with a little cotton ball. Ooh. The lipstick goes on with her finger. You need a little cotton applicator, which you're going to get with your first appointment. Done. And then you're going to book her again for a more advanced glamour appointment for next month. And that's when you're going to have some more things and you can try some different things and different techniques that you've learned for 3 months from now.
So you bring this to the next appointment?
Next appointment. Don't even bring that in your kit. Okay. Put it aside because you know what happens because you guys will just open your legs to everybody. You're like, oh, hang on. I have more stuff. No. She gets to wash her face and her hands. She gets CC cream and she leaves. Okay, and this is for your follow-up appointment. Every time you do not book a follow-up appointment, I want you to kiss $300 goodbye every single year for the rest of your life. The average customer spends $300 in a year, and they have to see you 3 times in order to do that. $300 every time. She needs to see you again, and you just treat it like the dentist does. Do you question the dentist when they're like, oh yeah, come back next month? You're like, okay. And you do. Okay, the chiropractor, you come back. Everybody comes back. So you just are like, whoop. Okay, we just need to book it. And guess what? Now you can have your friends come with you if she didn't have her friends first. Then you go early and you do this with her. You go, but you tell her the party's at 7, but tell your friends to come at 7:30. I'm going to come at 7. We're going to do your customized glamour appointment. You get to look smoking hot through the whole party. And your friends are going to try the basics like we did. And then they get to book their follow-up appointment with the color. Okay? This is how I did my business in the beginning. My first 300 faces were honestly just like this. Because it booked the party really, really easily. Because then I would come, early. She does her makeup. They all want this because she's looking really great. I don't do her makeup for her, by the way, because she is not keeping me in her closet to do it every day. And she will not buy it if she doesn't think she can do it on her own. So my makeup artists don't sell very much from what they, even if they have a line. They don't. It's because we are showing them that we sell. So now I'm going to go to her house. I'm going to show her how to do it. She's going to put it on. Everybody who comes in the door is like, wow, hottie. Because like lipstick, most people don't even wear lipstick. And then they're wearing lipstick. They're like, wow, you look good. And then their friends come in and you do the full skincare with them, whatever you've got, because you don't have a lot right now. Okay, tell her if you don't have a mascara yet and you've booked her for this, she can put her own damn mascara on. Chances are she's got some. Okay? Most women do. And if she doesn't have mascara, she doesn't care if she doesn't have it because she's never worn it before. Okay? So you're fine. You're fine. You all have friends in this business. You can all say, hey, I have an appointment tonight and I don't have a mascara. And one of us will lend you a mascara and some wands. You'll be fine. There is someone within a walking distance to your house, I promise. We're taking over Calgary one face at a time. Okay? So, just like that. Okay? Little bit, little bit, little bit. Then the next appointment. So you book your next appointment. Now you're going to say, what three friends do you want to have join you? Three. Not five, not 12. Three. Because you only have four mirrors. Okay? And she gets to help. She gets to be your ticket person. So she's going to help. And you know how hostesses are anyway. They're puttering around, get the food ready. Does everyone need anything? So she's happy. She gets to compliment everyone else at the table. Once you have more basic things in your kit, like Beach Blonde Cream Eyeshadow and a cheek blush and things like that, you can do a five-minute face with the rest of the guests, but she gets the glamour appointment. Then they can book their glamour appointment, and their friends get the basics, and she gets the hostess credit. Win, 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 win. And you get more names. And suddenly you're out of your friends and your family. Right? Because that's the goal. Questions, comments, concerns? Are y'all like, whoa?
You know so much.
Yeah, I have much knowledge. There's a reason I'm number two in Canada. Okay, so again, first thing at the appointment, you walk in, talk to her, chat. You know, it's usually your friend in your first 30 faces. It's someone you know or somebody who knows somebody you know. Right? So you're just like, oh, and how is so-and-so lately? Oh, good. And well, you're going to kind of weave your eye story in there, especially one-on-one. You don't want to be like, so, let me tell you about why I decided to start my Mary Kay business. She doesn't care. So you're going to weave it in. You're just going to be like, oh, yeah, and I love the stuff. That's why I decided to sell it. You know, we buy it for 50%, so it's really great. It's good profit margin. You know, I'm really excited because, like, we had such a good time on Monday night. Little thing, little. Then, satin hands at the sink, come back to the table, write it on her wish list, fill out the front of her order form, of her profile card, look at it and decide if she's normal to dry or combo to oily. Okay, give her your cleanser. Washy, washy, washy. Moisturize, microderm, CC cream. Okay, done. And then we're going to close the sale. You ready? Get ready to write stuff down. Okay. Now it's on. It's on like Donkey Kong, because this is the most important thing. Can I tell you that one of my very first experiences with Mary Kay, where somebody came to my house, was I had won in a welcome wagon draw. Somebody, like, you know, they do the welcome wagon, and I just moved into the neighborhood, and I won a manicure, and this is when Mary Kay sold hand stuff. So they sold, like, nail polish. They had this really awesome nail polish remover on a pump. I would, like, give my left arm to get it back because it was awesome. And they had all these steps for manicures and stuff, and I thought, I've never had a manicure. Of course I'd love to have somebody come over for a manicure. And we did satin hands, and she painted my nails, and she chatted with me. I liked her. She didn't ask if I wanted to buy anything. She just slid her catalog over and said, let me know if you want anything, and left. And I didn't buy anything. And she could have signed me up. So think about that, okay? The number one thing that I want you to remember when you're looking at sales is this. Women do not want to be sold to. They want permission to buy. They don't want to be sold to. We are very leery of salespeople in a traditional salesy kind of way. So I want you to think of your role as though you're the friend shopping with your friend, and she puts on the most killer leather jacket, that, like, makes her look like $10 million, like our skincare does. Your job is to be the friend going, if you do not get that jacket, I'm going to run you over with my truck in the parking lot. Like, I will disown you. That is your job, right? I mean, how many of you have gone shopping with a friend and you're like, dude, buy it. You know you want to get it. You know you can afford it. Buy it. Okay? So slightly less than that because she's not your friend yet, but you're just sort of helping her buy. That's it. Can you look at it that way? You are not trying to con her out of your money. You are not trying to trick her. You are not trying to get her to help you pay for something. Your goal is actually to get her the product that she actually really likes and that will help her skin. Because I don't know about you, but I would hand this stuff out for free on the street if I could. Because I love it so much. There's so many people that could use it. Like, I would tackle people and wash their faces if I could. Okay? Especially when, you know, people are like, oh, yeah, you look so young. What's your secret? I don't know, washing. It's just a thing. So, you are just being that friend for her. So, with her wish list in front of you, so you've got your wish list, you're done the appointment. You're going to go back to the beauty book. Sorry, I'm going to grab
that. And you have her fill in the wish list?
She's, no, this is a facial. So I filled in the wish list, but it's in front of us the whole time so that she sees it too. Then I go to the back of the beauty book and I go, okay, so, you know, we're in your 30s. So this is what Mary Kay recommends for a full product line. Now, just remember, you don't have to start here. You don't have to end here. I'm not going anywhere. Just like that. You don't have to start here. You don't have to end here. I am not going anywhere. I will be here for your skincare needs for a very long time. And if not, can you promise me this? If you ever do decide to quit, you will make sure your customers are taken care of. Please. Because you don't know. I've gone through 5 different consultants in my time, and if just one of them had passed me to somebody good and I didn't have to find them, I could have started this a long time earlier. And this is what sets my whole soul on fire. So I'm so mad at them that they didn't. Okay? Just pass them on to somebody that's good, that you know will take care of them. That's it. Sister sales director, sister sales consultants, I don't care. Just pass them on because they deserve to be taken care of and they deserve to not have to find somebody new. So go through this. Say, I'm not going anywhere. You can start with all of this or you don't have to end here either. You can have more than this. You can have less than this. Totally up to you. This is just what Mary Kay recommends for you. That's it. This is just what Mary Kay recommends for you. So we recommend the Miracle Set. I'm just going to stick with the 30s because that tends to be everybody's age range. Most of us, we're all around the same age. So you're probably going to be late 20s to early 40s. That's probably where your main demographic is going to be. Okay? So you're starting in your 30s. You're going to say the Miracle Set. So that is, and you don't put your product away. So that is your cleanser and your moisturizer that we tried and sort of romance those. And the day and night solution that I talked about, we didn't get to try yet. That is the microdermabrasion set that we tried. And that's on your wish list, right? And she's like, yeah, I loved that. And moisture renewing gel mask, just because in our 30s, we tend to get dry, even if we're oily, tend to, you know, need a little bit of extra help. And of course, the non-negotiable firming eye cream, which we didn't get to try yet, but you would love. Just like that. You're going to love that. It's amazing. Don't forget, this link will be up for 24 hours. So if you need me, you need to go back through it, that's okay. I think I have it saved too to my gallery, so I can always save it to YouTube and then post it as well. So don't panic. Okay, so just that. Okay, so you're going to give her that, and then you're going to give her this little sheet that's in with your beauty bag. This has everything in sets. See? So without the gel mask, that's the ultimate miracle set. You're going to add in a foundation or CC cream of your choice. That's the ultimate miracle set right here. So you can start here. Okay, why do you think McDonald's sells in value meals, you guys? Are you really saving money?
Nope.
Not really, because you probably didn't even need the large fries. You would have probably been perfectly satisfied with 4 fries out of the bottom of the bag from your kids' meals, right? But we buy the value meal because it says value and because it's a set. These are sets. They are designed to help you sell. This is called menu selling. So you start with this very first one, the biggest one. The Ultimate Miracle Set is $257. Notice that there's no prices on these. So you're going to have to, you can put little stickers with the prices or you can just memorize them. You only get one pack, one per beauty pack. So if you want more, you can photocopy these. They are available, I think, on MKOC as well to print off.
So you get one hard copy
of this. One hard copy of this, okay? So don't scribble all over it. This is just inside the beauty books.
Okay.
It's just shoved in there. So the Ultimate Miracle Set's the most expensive. $257. Don't say $257. Do you know why?
It's scary.
Scary. Dollars is scary. Only say dollars if they're saving money. This will last you for 6 to 9 months. Chance, most people, it's 6 months. Mary Kay's thing says 3. I've never had anybody go through skincare in 3 months. It's always 6 months. So twice a year, right? Microdermabrasion, though, lasts for about a year of once a week use. There's 52 applications in it. And you have your day-night solution, you have your foundation, which can last 6 months to a year. This is a pretty good investment when you think about it. So $257 for the Ultimate Miracle Set plus their choice of foundation, because we do have different prices for your foundation. CC Cream is $22 and our matte wear is $23.50. So they just put it like that. Plus your choice of foundation. That's where we recommend most people ages 25 to 45 start. Right there. Easy. If that, and you say this, if that is too much product for you to start with, not if that is too much money for you, if that is too much product for you to start with, then you can just go to the Miracle Set, which is your cleanser, your moisturizer, and your day and night solution. This is $157. Go to the Miracle Set. So if that's too much product for you, you can go to the Miracle Set, which is $157. Plus your choice of foundation.
So it could be a little more than $157, depending on the body.
It would be more than $157. So $157 is just the Miracle Set.
Oh.
And then we recommend the foundation on top, but they don't have to get the foundation. But they always do, okay? We have an age-defying set, which is just your microdermabrasion and your firming eye cream. That's $100. That's $100, like that. And again, a year's supply of microdermabrasion and 6 months supply of firming eye cream. Easy. We have the repair set, which isn't for you, so we just skip it, okay, unless they're 50 and up. Then you start here, okay? Flip to the back. There's a lot more sets here. Flawless Finish, Botanical, Simple and Sleek, Replenishing Serum C, Even Complexion Regimen, Clear Proof, Satin Lips, Satin Hands, Indulge, and your Skin Vigorate Brush. It's just designed to give them an option for shopping, because here's what happens. If you have them in the catalog now, they just do this.
And it's overwhelming.
They might ask you a lot of questions. They're buying nothing, okay? You're not going to hide the catalog. You're not like, no, you can't have it, okay? But you're going to give them the catalog, but at first you're going to pick their skincare. So you say, so, Janice, where did you want to start today? And then you shut up. And this is why this order form is blank. Do not give it to her to fill out. You are going to look at her profile card. You are going to keep your eyes down. You are going to get your body as small as possible, because if you are in this position, you have power and she doesn't, and she knows it. If you shrink down, she feels like she's in control. She's looking here and at the beauty book only, not the catalog yet. Okay? She will ask you questions. You are going to slowly copy her address and phone number and all that things from the top on the top of the order form. Slowly. Like, as though you have struggled in school with this. Very slowly. Quiet and looking down. She's looking at the beauty book. She's flipping through the beauty book. She's got her profile card at the back of the wish list. You're going to flip it over and let her see the wish list after you're done copying. You're going to slowly write your name and your phone number until she starts talking. And she'll say where she wants to start. I'm going to start with the cleanser and moisturizer today. Okay, great. And you write that down. You do not put the prices there. Do not put the prices beside it. Because what happens when she sees the prices, even though they're right beside her, is she starts mathing. The second she starts mathing, she starts stressing. You want shopping to be a fun experience for her, not a negative one. So don't put the prices. So you're just going to write time-wise, 3-in-1 cleanser, combo to oily. And sit there. It's painful at first. I'm not going to lie. It is not fun because if she's a slow talker, whew, you're going to be like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. And she'll say, you know what? No, I... Do not jump in. Yeah, I think you should get the miracle... No, shut up. Okay? I think I am going to get the miracle set. Oh, perfect. That's exactly where I would tell you to start. I don't care if she's only going to get the primer. That's exactly where I would tell you to start. That's a great place to start. Compliment her on her choice. Compliment her. Because she is purchasing something. That's better than nothing.
What do you say if they say nothing? And then, you've already filled out this sheet.
That's fine. Because you've only started with skincare. Oh. Right? So you're just like, which skincare option did you want to start with today? Because okay. It's just skincare there. Okay? And you're like, that's totally okay. So I'm just going to point you towards the back of the catalog here. And then, see these little hearts in the back of the catalog? I like to trace the little hearts with what we did. So I like to go, we did the cleanser, and we did the moisturizer. So once she's looked at the sets, so she looks at the sets first, because she's more likely to buy in a set. She just really is. I don't know. There's something about sets we just buy. But then I'm going to go, okay, so we tried this, and we tried this. And you had said that you thought that you would like the firming eye cream, so I'm going to circle that. Just trace the hearts, okay? Trace the hearts for her and then hand it to her. And then shut up. Once again, if she's taking a really long time and you feel like you cannot wait any longer, slowly start packing up. Do not take her mirror away till the very end. The mirror is the last thing to go. Do you know why? Because she's looking at herself. The more she likes what she sees, the more she will buy. And then when she says, yeah, that's good, then you can start writing the prices in if you want, but you are way better off to look at her like this and go, when was the last time you replaced your mascara? Unless she bought one. When was the last time you replaced your mascara? Head tilt, look in one eye only. When was the last time you replaced your mascara? And she's going to say, it's been a while. Like, do you know you're supposed to replace it every 3 months? She's like, yes. And then I go, well, we have a few options. They're really inexpensive. They're a great purchase for a premium mascara. And they're guaranteed. Which one would you like? Not, do you want one? Which one would you like? Because you need one. And usually she's like, yeah, I do. And you're like, okay. And then you go, do you have an eye makeup remover? No. You want one? Like this. You want one? Yeah. Write it down. Yeah, here's the thing, you guys. A woman will not overspend. Okay, you're not being pushy by asking her. It's like when you go to Reitman's and they're like, hey, by the way, the jewelry is 3 for $20. Do you know how many? Do you know the stats on that? Do you know that 80% of women will turn around and they'll go look at the jewelry that they had no intention of buying? And they will buy the jewelry? Why do you think Walmart has that huge aisle to get to the front? And they have very few people on till. Do you know why? So you upsell. So you buy more. That's why. I would really recommend, especially in the beginning, when you add it up, $10 a face per 100 faces is $1,000. You sell an extra mascara to 100 people, you've got $1,000. And they're happy because they have great mascara and they're going to keep buying it for 3 times a year or 4 times a year. But get a little basket. Buy some lip glosses, buy some eyeshadows, things like that. Unwrap them so that you can see what the color is so that they don't have to open the box and put them in a little basket right beside where they're purchasing. They will dig and they will buy. How many times have you been at the till and you've been digging and buying? Right? Okay, they will dig and buy. I'll take this too. Okay, great, no problem. Okay? Take the dollar signs out of your eyes. This is not about how much money you can make. Really, it's about how much you can help her get the things she wants. Does that make sense? That's really it. Because what happens is if you're thinking about how much money you can make, you're coming from a place of guilt because you're all guilty because you think, oh, gosh, you know, you don't know her finances. So when you talk her out of something she could have afforded, she thinks I'm poor, she thinks this, she doesn't like that. So those are negative feelings too. Not talking to her out of those things. And do not total until she says, and that's it. And if she puts down the catalog and turns away from you, a body language, start to read her body language, then you total. I remember once I was at a party, like a home party, and I expected to spend $100. In fact, I had $100 cash in my back pocket that I was going to spend. I told her two things, and then I got distracted, and somebody was talking to me, and I turned around, and she gave me my total. And I would have bought more, and I told her that. I was like, too bad for you. I was going to spend $100. You only let me spend $27. She's like, what? Well, yeah, you totaled me up too fast. Don't total too fast. This is not when you want to be efficient. You are not the Walmart clerk. You do not want to be fast here.
So don't feel the pressure if you've got a lot of people waiting.
Yeah, don't feel the pressure. And that's why I try and sneak away with them. Or like go, like if it's at a party, then I just talk to Tammy just over here. Right? And I just sort of answer people as I go. You know, but that's where it's nice if you have somebody with you. Always try and bring a team member or somebody with you to a party. I always do. I always have somebody with me. I'm spoiled rotten now. So I'll start posting because I haven't been posting. I've got people still that have been coming. But, yeah, and then you can come and be my little assistant and watch me how I do it, right? And so, like, that's something that we do. And, yeah, and so then they can help with the lip glosses or whatever. But usually they're busy eating in the kitchen anyway. So I'm going to sneak over with her. I'm going to total Tammy up. I'm going to give her a total, take her payment. Then I'm going to go over to you. And I'm going to book a follow-up, don't forget. Then I'm going to go over here. We'll do party training later anyway, but most of the time what you're doing right now is one-on-ones anyway. So just focus on one or two people at a time. That's the magic. Like, just an extra person at least. Just one extra. Who do you know that would like to come? Just say that. Who do you know that would like to come? Total it up and don't say, how would you like to pay for this? Never use the word pay. Okay, please say, how would you like to take care of this today? I take credit cards or e-transfer. E-transfer is really popular. It's really popular. And with phones, at least you can check your email right there and know you got it. E-transfer is great. Credit cards are great. Cash is very rare. So don't worry about carrying a bunch of change around. Change, I pop it in their bag when I give them their product. That's it. Yeah, I used to. In the very beginning, I had a cash bag, but those are the days before e-transfers, before you could swipe a credit card in advance, things like that. I don't recommend taking checks unless it's from someone you know. Not with the days of e-transfer. You don't need to. Okay? And then you're going to give the pink slip to her, and on yourself, you're going to increase her satisfaction, and then you are going to get her more excited, and she's going to tell her friends right away. So if you can invest in product and have product on hand, it's a good idea. You will sell about 43% more if you have product on hand, even if it's a little bit. Even if you can give her one thing out of her order, it makes a big difference. You know this already, right? Yeah.
We just up my sales, like with that Halloween ad that we did, I up my sales by like probably 5% just from the makeup remover because I had a whole bunch on hand.
So see?
Like, here.
Exactly. And then they're excited right away. They get immediate feedback. They get it immediately. They're way more likely to post about it or tweet about it or whatever. Okay? So if you haven't made an inventory decision yet, there is a video on my new transformers. I'm not going to go through it today, but go through that. Watch that no matter what position you're in. No matter, even if you've already bought and you're like, I don't know, okay, you might want product later. And, you know, there's different ebbs and flows in our lives. So typically what we recommend for part-time consultants is to have 3,000 on their shelves. For full-time, it's 5,000. Most people do not start at 3. Most people do not start at 5. They start small and build up. It's just the same as this may have all the things you recommend, but you do not have to purchase them all right off the bat. Okay? So the sets... The beauty of the sets, the $257 makes her feel way less guilty for spending $82. And she'll go home and she'll be like, well, she wanted me to buy a $300 set. And I didn't, because I'm amazing. And then she'll spend $80 next month, and $80 next month, and $80 next month, because now you've got her on follow-up appointments. And you know what? They really like them. So I want you to just change your thinking. Before we wrap up, I want you to think, this is not a business where you are asking them to do you a favor. You're not. You are the favor. You are the favor. I was in Sephora in Palm Springs. Okay, we just thought we'd look around, and it's kind of funny because we're all Mary Kay directors. So we were like, well, we'll go look in Sephora. Holy cow! And it was a small one. Overwhelming. I asked a guy, what's the best foundation? Oh, here. And then he's like, let's put you into my computer and let's ask you 75 questions. And then here, let's give you 40 different kinds that you can choose from. What? Okay, that's too overwhelming. Most of our customers love that about us, that we can give them those things, that they can try before they buy, that they can get 100% money back guarantee. Mm-hmm. So you're not asking them to, you're not giving them a root canal. So when you're asking them for an appointment, it's not like, oh, you want to have an appointment with me? Okay, you are offering them something really, really great. They love us. Like, our loyalty is high. People would buy everything from us. They would buy socks and underwear if we sold it. Okay, they would buy deodorant. There's a reason we used to sell vitamins. Had nothing to do with the actual vitamin. It had lots to do with the fact that they didn't want to go buy anything else. They were like, oh, you recommend that? Great, I'll buy that too. And that, and that. You guys were almost, were you all customers? Yes. No, just one. Okay.
Like,
no, you
I
never did.
I had like once for a friend.
That's right.
I heard about this.
Yeah, so that you're the rare. Most of our consultants were customers first. And the reason they want to be consultants is because they loved the product. So think about when you were a customer. And if I had called you and said, hey, I'm booking people for a pumpkin spice eye look. Do you want to try it? You would have said yes. You would have. You would have said yes. And yeah, you probably would have said to your friend, hey, come over for coffee. My friend's coming over to teach me how to do a pumpkin spice eye look. It's really pretty. You want to come and get an extra friend there? So why do we think we have to bribe them to do that? Why do we think we have to be like, oh my gosh, please, please. No, we don't. I mean, they want you, okay? They want what you have to offer. So no matter what, whether you think you're an expert now or not, because you're not, that's okay, because you don't have to be. Every single face in my first 100 faces got mineral powder and ivory too. Didn't matter if it wasn't the right color. They got honey spice, moonstone, and sweet plum. Because that was one of the color cards, so I only bought that one because it looked good on everybody. They got strawberry cream blush. No, shy blush. Sorry, I'm wrong. Shy blush. And they got maple lipstick. And Fancy Nancy Cafe au lait for lip gloss. That's it. Everybody got the same thing. And you know what? Those customers from 500 faces ago or 700 faces ago, they still buy those same products from me and more. Because they're great. So they just keep buying those, and then they buy more. Okay? I promise. The business is not hard. Make it fun. Make it simple. And the reason that your starter kit is so simple is so that you actually do it and that you're not terrified to do it. So again, wash your hands. Ready? Everybody say, wash your hands.
Wash your hands.
Now wash your face.
Now wash your face.
Now what do you want to buy?
Now what do you want to buy?
Done. She will buy things you did not try because she likes the things she did try. So she trusts those products and will buy more. Isn't that true? When you were buying from a department store or a drugstore, if you liked CoverGirl mascara, you were more likely to go to the CoverGirl counter and buy the CoverGirl lip gloss, weren't you? Mm-hmm. You didn't have to try it first. They're the same way. Any questions before we wrap up? I know I've broken you all. You're like tired now. You're done. You're done. You're at the done. This is why we stopped doing it on a Saturday morning, because we used to do it from 9 to 1 on a Saturday.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. The only other thing I want to cover for you is this. This is the weekly accomplishment sheet. I know this seems like a lot, but it isn't. This is available under resources on MKOC and forms and worksheets. So I just happen to have a bunch, so I'm going to give them to you. This is the best way to keep track of your money because it's very easy to lose it. Because what happens is then you buy some things for yourself and you buy a couple of gifts for your friends and then you're like, well, I don't have any money from Mary Kay. Well, whoops, you spent that money. You spent it. That's where it went. Okay, so on here, you're just going to put the name of your hostess or your facial and you're going to, do you see this category right here where it says all the way from time to number of skincare sets sold? Okay, you're going to fill out each of those columns right here. You're going to fill out each of these columns. So the time you invested, okay, the number of orders that you got, the number of bookings you got, and the number of skincare sets you sold. So if it's Carol, here, I'll do it really quick, okay? So the date, Carol, and her phone number, 403, blah, 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 okay? Time invested, 1 hour. Number of calls I had to make to get that appointment, one. I had to, got one order because it's just a facial, right? I got one follow-up booking, and I sold her a cleanser and a moisturizer. That's a basic. Okay, basic is your cleanser and moisturizer. So that's 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, straight across. Cool? Okay, then this next one, you're only filling out one of those columns for your sales. So if it was a facial, which it was, then I'm going to put the total of retail that I spent, that she spent there. Not the GST, not discounts, just retail, the subtotal. So that's 180. Let's say she spent at that appointment. So 180 goes there. These boxes don't get filled in. Like that. Okay? This way, when you're done the month or done the week and you've got a month's worth to look at, you can say, oh, my facial averages are quite high, but my on-the-goes are quite low. Or I don't have any website orders. Maybe I need to fix that. I don't have that many trunk shows. Or my trunk shows averages are way higher than my facials. Maybe I need to do more of those. Okay? Think about that. That's where you get this concept here. So you're just filling out one of those columns. You're going to put the GST right here, the sales tax. So I don't know what the sales tax would be, so I'm making up a number, $4.15. If I gave her a $5 gift from section two, like, you know, samples or something, whatever amount of dollars that those worked, that would go there. The product I gave away, I gave her $10 off her order, so $10 goes there. You don't have to give discounts. This is just, you know. And non-recovered sales taxes if I didn't charge the GST on the subtotal. You have two ways to do your business. Personally, I know there's going to be people who disagree with me. I know, whatever. I don't like doing extra paperwork. So I just charge the GST on the subtotal. Mm-hmm. I don't charge the GST on the discounted and then submit it to Mary Kay to get the money back. Okay? Because kill me slowly. So you just do that. And you add up your columns at the end of the week. Okay? And then you can see how much money you're making per hour. You can see what your gross profit was. Yes, it says 40% here because 10% should go back into your business in business supplies, catalogs, events, things like that, okay? 10% tends to disappear in any business. That's why it's nice that we make 50% because in a business when you're making 20% and 10% goes back, that's not a lot of profit.
No.
Okay? So 50%, and so you just kind of figure that out, and then you can show your husband or your boyfriend or your mother-in-law or whatever the money you're making. No matter if you spent it, it doesn't matter. You don't go to your paychecks and say, well, I mean, I did have $1,500, but I spent it on, I don't know, rent. Like, you don't do that, right? So it's the same with this. This is your job. So you made that money. You still made that money. What you chose to do with it is up to you. And you can actually track your expenses on another sheet. There's another sheet in on it on forms and worksheets that you can track your expenses. On the back, this is if you are submitting it to me. If you feel the need to submit me this damn paperwork, feel free. I might read it. Send it to me, please, in a picture file, not a PDF. If you want to do this, just screen cap it. Like, just, okay? Text it to me or Facebook it to me. Don't feel that you have to, okay? But it does kind of help you with your goals and your hourly earnings and all of that stuff, okay? If you want to recruit, all you have to do is show her these for a few weeks. And she sees that you're making $30 an hour. You can't make that at Walmart. So instead of saying, well, I only had a $300 week, yeah, how many hours did you work? Two. So you made $150 in 2 hours. So you made $75 an hour. Oh, yeah. That's pretty impressive, right? There's not very many jobs you can work for $75 an hour that don't involve you standing on a street corner. Okay? That's it. So, yeah. Depends how good you are, I guess. Some of us would be standing there ain't nobody want it. So, you know, just, yeah. Okay, so any questions about this? They are available on MKOC. You don't have to have a whole pad of them printed out. You can use these. There's a fillable one on Microsoft Word that you can do right on your computer, too. Okay? Just, I'm just asking you, start now. It's way better to start now than to go back and do 7 months later because taxes or whatever else, and you're like, oh, I guess I'm supposed to do that. Just start now. Get a clear sense of how much money you're making. Don't let your money slip away. Don't let it go away because it goes away very fast. Think about if somebody gives you cash for something. How long does that stick around? It's just gone. And that's what happens. And then that's why people quit, is either poor emotional management, poor time management, or poor money management. Those are the three reasons people quit in this business. If you don't want to quit and you want to be here, even if it's just to get your product for free, then that's what you're going to do. Okay? Good? Any questions?
I have some questions.
Yes.
Well, it's kind of about sales. So after you do your first order, mm-hmm. which is, you have the 60 days.
Yeah.
What's the next one?
Once you're an active consultant, so you've done your first order, okay, so let's call that month one. So you just did your order, your inventory order and your sales order and all that. That's your month. Pardon?
How do you know that?
Because you're on my team. I know these things. Okay, so you just did your order. So that's month one. Then month two and three, you can place any size orders you want. So that's October. So then November and December, you don't even have to order.
Okay.
If you don't, I mean, you'll have customers and you'll have reorders. So you don't have to order though.
Okay.
Okay, so you always get 50% off. Once January hits, then you have to at least order 225 in one bulk order.
Retail?
Wholesale. 450 retail.
Sorry, say
okay.
You've already ordered your 250 of product?
Yeah. Yes. So,
and you did a part, and you made a big sale.
I did one debut party and sold quite a bit. Like $1,500 worth of stuff.
Jesus.
Mm-hmm. In 4 hours.
Yeah, she rocks.
Yeah,
exactly. Mm-hmm. Okay, so month one is the month you do your order. You have your first 60 days from when you signed in to do your first order of at least 225 wholesale. Okay? Chances are you want to do more than that because you don't get any free stuff unless you do a 600 wholesale order, so $1,200 retail. But doesn't matter. Your minimum is that. So once you've done that, you have 2 months that we call a grace period. Okay, it's basically a gift from Mary Kay, and they give you 2 months where you don't have to make a minimum order in order to get your 50% profit.
So if you do the 450 retail order in those 2 months, does that count?
Then you're back to month one.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so anytime you do a 225, you're back to month one. So for example, I'm always A1, active one, because it goes active one, active two, active three. Okay, so this is, A1, A2, A3. So whenever you place a 450 retail order, 225 wholesale, and it is described on the group too. I have a full thing that says, so you just want to order for yourself, it's under the pictures. So just find it, and it's got it all described there if you need it. So you don't have to scribble frenetically, I promise. So first month that you order, you're active, okay? If you want to order in these 2 months, you can at any size. So, for example, if you ordered $600 here, and then you broke your leg, and you couldn't sell anything in this month, that's okay. And then this month, you sold 2 satin hands. Well, that's not even $225, but that's okay, because you can still order it and get your discount. Totally fine. Once month four hits, then you are in a P status.
What does that mean?
P is probationary, but it doesn't mean that you're in jail. Okay, so it just means you're not active. So that means whenever it says P beside, it'll say it right on web reporting. When you go to your name on web reporting, it'll say what your active status is. And if it has a P there, that means your next order has to be 450 retail.
To get you back.
To get you back to 50% off. Otherwise, you're paying retail, and don't do that. Do not do that. Promise me, all y'all, do not do that. Figure out a way. Just figure out a way to get your discount. Please, dear God, do not be paying shipping and full price. You might as well buy it through a consultant. Okay? That doesn't make any sense to me. And Mary Kay's really good about that. So, you know, they'll tell you. They'll be like, what are you doing, crazy head? So don't do that. Okay? You didn't sign up so you could buy it at full price plus $12 shipping. But you, whenever you do your 225, you're going back up to the top. And then you're an active consultant again. The advantages to being an active consultant is you never have to worry about what size the order your orders are. And if you have customers all over Canada or even far away from you, you can drop ship to them and direct ship straightly from the company, which is cheaper than shipping from your shelf. So even if you have product on hand and you try and order it and put it through Canada Post, it's way more expensive. So, and this is UPS, it's at their door in 3 days, right? So you can just log in and just ship. It's easy. Good?
When you say direct ship from Mary Kay.
From Mary Kay head office, yeah. So it just comes to them in a little box. They don't get the sales slip that says the discount. They only get the sales slip that says what they ordered. That's it. And it has a little thing in it that says thank you for your order. It's pretty good. They're really good that way. So like I just did like 12 direct ship orders from my sale, and I just shipped them all straight to their house. UPS or Canada Post.
And then what did you do for shipping? That was one of my questions, is the shipping cost?
I just charge everybody $2.
Okay.
Every single order. Anna usually takes my order forms in advance and writes $2 in that spot in advance so that I can't skip it. If I feel I want to take it off, then I just subtract the $2, and she thinks she got a really great deal.
So they can do direct ship to the individual houses.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Canada Post or UPS. Yeah, apartment buildings, anything. They're really good. Yeah, and it's only $9. So, like, to ship a cleanser and a moisturizer is, like, $15. It's insane. You can ship a big box. You can ship $200 worth of product for direct ship for $9. They're pretty good. So it's worth it. Even the $12. I can get 12 boxes shipped to me, for, and still I only pay $12. There's no other company that does that. It's all based on weight. Mm-hmm. Ours is not. Okay, so you don't have to. I mean, lots of these direct sales companies, like, Jamie, what was Pampered Chef? But like,
for direct?
Yeah.
It depends on weight. Weight. So it could go way up there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. And with I that, it's heavy.
Very heavy, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, see? So then most of our customers are like, $2, who cares? They will pay. That's not a problem. So,
if you're doing a one-on-one facial,
yeah,
then what do you do if it's a one, like a single appointment?
But you're still ordering, you're doing a bulk order to yourself.
Okay.
Like, if she lives anywhere near you, you're just collecting as many orders as you can, then you do a bulk order, and then you distribute those orders. Okay, but otherwise, if she doesn't live near you, and you're like, oh, I'm not going to go drive to Saskatchewan, right? So then you just ship directly from the company. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so then, like, otherwise, your parties, everything else comes to you, and then you distribute from there. Good? So A1, A2, A3 is just your active status. Once you're here, then, you know, you get your 50% off any size order. P means that you have to order $225 on your next order. Once you do, you are back to month one. If this expires and you get all the way through 12 months and you haven't done a $225, there are no pink baseball batted men that are coming to your house to beat you. All that has to happen is you have to buy your starter kit again. And then you can sign up and sell again. But if you don't want to do that, then you just make sure to order the $225. So technically, you could place one order here and then go all the way to number 11 and then do another $225. But that's a long time to be without your product. And if you have a few customers, you're going to lose those few customers because you aren't dealing with them regularly. So it's not recommended, but the minimum requirement is basically one order in a year. Okay? You were going to ask me something.
Oh, it's okay.
Did it answer? No, it's okay. Go.
Well, it's so... I already did my 450.
Yeah.
So then let's say I did one for like 100,
mm-hmm.
and then one for 600. My next one mandatory has to be 450.
Nope, your 600 would count as a 450, so it brings you back to A1.
So I don't have the 60 days again. It could be any time.
Any time.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. The 60 days was just for your first order.
Okay.
That's it for your free stuff. Okay? That's it.
Okay. So every time you put in a 225, doesn't matter if it's month 2.5.
You're back to A1. Yeah.
So you have 3 months from your last 225 order.
You have the month you ordered and the next two. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So if it's the 30th of the month and you did it, then you only have 1 day.
Okay.
And then your 2 months. So okay. Calendar months. Yeah, it's calendar months, not dates.
Just order once a month.
Yeah. You can do 225 every month and be fine. You're always going to be active. You can do, yeah. Most selling consultants never have to worry about this.
So the only way that you go to not getting your 50% discount is if you put in, like, say month 6, you haven't ordered anything for 4 months, and month 6 you only put in a $60 order, you're paying 100%.
You're paying 100%, and don't do that.
Only if you...
Call somebody on our team and
buddy up. Do they get warning emails?
Yeah, I do. I get it. It goes in the whole file. Yeah, and you do. You're all on. We have a thing called a V card service, and it comes. It's not the same as a normal V card, and it's virtual, and it just comes to your thing, and it says, "Don't forget that your order thing is expiring." Same as you'll get one when you're in A3, so that you can take advantage of this and order whatever you want that and not have to do 225. Because lots of people don't. Then they just wait till their next 225 and order collect as many orders as possible. Okay. So, does that make sense? It's really, really, like, don't overcomplicate it. It is really as simple as it sounds.
It shows the date on your MKOC order form, too. It goes like,
yeah. Your order expires here. But that doesn't mean your agreement expires. So don't think that means that you're not a consultant anymore. Okay? You're a consultant for 11 months from your first 225. Even if you never order again. You're still a consultant. You just can't order anything unless you order at bulk amount. That's why we can afford to give 50%, because if we were doing it the way some other companies do, where you just order for this customer and order for this customer and order for this customer, that costs a lot in processing fees. And that's where they can only afford to give you 20 to 25%. But that's not in Mary Kay. They can give you the 50%, right? So, yeah. Does that make sense? Good?
Is there a special date that has to be ordered?
No. For you, you signed in October, so you would have till November 30th. It's like, it's not 60 exact days. It's the month you sign in and your next month to do your first order.
But you can put an order through any day.
Yeah.
Anytime.
So look at the inventory video, make a decision. If you've already made a decision, cool beans, keep going. Doesn't matter what your decision is, I will still love you. And then we will just go forward from there. Okay?
Inventory video is on...
New Transformers, and it's a YouTube one.
So when you say New Transformers, is that the Facebook?
That's the Facebook group, yeah. Are you not a Facebooker? You just gave me that look. Like,
there's a lot of stuff going on Facebook, and I don't always get a chance to fully explore.
As new people, if you have to decide where to go, to the new one only.
Yeah.
Skip, unfollow the Transformers Future National Area one, unfollow your group one, just look at New Transformers for now, okay? And then go from there. I don't even want to know what you guys are doing. Children, what do you have? Put the chips back.
Chips.
No. Oh my gosh. Like your IQ needs to become question there. Like really, I'll just back out of the garage where I sure have a place to be.
If you do a 6-month order, you get free stuff.
And yes.
Yeah, I did that. The next month.
Then you're on the qualifying. Yes, so you get the consistency bonuses.
Yeah, so if you do another $600 order next month, then you still get free stuff even though it's
that's right. So as long as you did your first month, okay? Thank you for reminding me about that. So in your first 2 months, as long as you do a $600 or, well, even if you do $225 in your first order, okay? Then, no!
He's pouting.
Dude, turn around, let me see. What's in your butt? Yeah, I knew it! Gosh! Go put that in the fridge and go upstairs. Forget it.
What's the 600 thing again? Sorry.
600 wholesale you get free stuff. Yeah. And then if you do a 600 wholesale again the next month, you get more free stuff. And then if you do a 600 the next month, you get more free stuff. So there's a bunch of bundles. They're all about $100 each or more. And so you get to pick from there which bundle you want. It's a great way to build your inventory.
Is it an order of 600 or is it?
One order of 600. It's one order because it's so hard for them to keep track of that. Yeah.
The girl that recruited me did that. She did all of her like 450 like cumulative. And she's like, that didn't work.
No, that
so
doesn't work.
Active and she's like, what happened?
Yeah, no. So one order.
Do you wait till you have another like retail or wholesale?
Wholesale. We're talking wholesale. So your goal is that your first order gets done in your first 2 months. Okay. Who's done their first order? Okay. Don't do an order without talking to me.
You know what? I have no idea.
Okay, good. I will help you because we don't want you to miss out.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. People miss out on free bonuses all the time. Then in month two, if you do 600 in one order, you get to pick a bundle. There's a whole list of bundles to pick from. And this video that I have on the group explains that. So I'll bump it to the top, I promise. Okay. So you pick one of those bundles. Then the next month, if you do 600, you pick one of the bundles. But it is a consistency bonus, so if you skip a month, you're done.
How long does it go for?
6 months, I think. There's as many bundles. I think it's 6 months. Okay. Brand new, so yeah, I'm pretty sure it's 6 months. Okay, so and anyone on Periscope that wants to disagree with me, go ahead, tell me if I'm wrong. So month 3, 4, 5, and 6, I'm pretty sure, or I think it might be 6 after that. But you get a new bundle every time. Well, that can work out to $700 worth of free product just for doing your job. So 600 is really seeing 15 phases.
You know how if your inventory orders like 1800, you get like two free bundles?
Yes.
And then if you did like 1800 the next month, let's just say
you get three more bundles.
Another, mm-hmm. And then,
three more.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You get to pick the bundles based on your order.
Okay.
Yeah. It's pretty good that way.
Yeah.
So yeah, so you get to count those. I'm pretty sure. Because Pauline just did that, and she did 1,200 the next month. She got to pick two bundles, but it'll come up as it'll come up as an option. Because that way we don't want people holding on to orders either, so that they can be part of the consistency. But I think you lose out if Like, you hit a maximum no matter what, right? Okay. But, yeah, so, I mean, there's all these free bonuses, and that's how they do it so that if an inventory decision is too much for you and you do 1,800 or something like that and it's too much, then at least you can do 225 or 600 to start. Then each month that you do 600, you get more bonuses. So they're basically rewarding you on selling, and then you get that free stuff. You get that $100 for the free product. You can turn around and sell that, or you can use it for demos. Okay? I promise it's explained better with it right in front of me on the YouTube link, so I'll send you guys that. Okay? I'll actually post it on the event. Does that sound better?
Yeah, sure.
Then you can see it right away.
The video is really helpful.
Mm-hmm.
It's,
it's terrible. Like, I need to do a new nice one. I know. I'm like trying to do it in like a selfie thing, and I'm like this. Like, it's, and but it was backwards, and I, oh, it was driving me crazy. And then so I had to turn it around, but then I couldn't tell if I was in the thing or not. So I had a mirror behind it to try and like, yeah, it's terrible. It's not good quality. You may get seasick. But it works, and it just has that on there. So just take a look at that. It's all under Ready, Set, Sell on MKOC as well, if you want to take a look there. If you like it better in paper form and not so spazzy, then you can check it up there. Okay? Somebody else is vibrating. Any more questions, comments, concerns? Okay, I'm going to shut this off. Bye, everybody.
So was your, how many people were?